Welcome to Melbourne Ballpark for the finale of a four-game set between the Melbourne Aces and the Sydney Blue Sox. Yesterday, the Aces held 2-4-1 leads, and I mean that in the sense that they sent a 5-1 lead and then an 8-4 lead, ended up losing the game by a score of 12-8 in extra innings. Back here for the finale of a four-game set, Alex Gullum here, joined by Craig Koenig, and, well, Fritta, Aces looking to salvage the series here today. They win 2-2 split. If they lose, they fall in the series 1-3.
Yeah, they really need to get to say split this series. The last thing we want to do is lose series at home. Last night was a bit of a heartbreak. They're holding the lead going into the ninth, and the Aces were looking really good. It was a massive game last night. 10 home runs, 27 runs in total scored, 10 pitches used in that game. We're out of here. So seeing how they can bounce back here, confidence-wise and for morale in the team, we're really going to hope they can bounce back to take a win today.
Starting for the Aces will be Brady Hayden Godbold. Godbold making his first start of the season. No regular 4.05 ERA in 3 innings. This is 4 1/3 innings pitch, 2 RBIs, 3 strikeouts, and 3 walks. He will see Bortnick and Dean to begin the first inning. Defensive alignment for the Aces, right to left in the outfield. Wern, Engel, and Hendricks, right to left in the infield. Deglan, Cruz, Harmon, Davies, the catcher, Numata, after an off day behind the dish yesterday. Ready versus ready, first pitch fastball that's taken on the inside corner for a strike, and we are underway here at the beautiful Melbourne Ballpark. Bark at the park day. Some pooches in it do get a ticket. A one offering, fastball swung on, driven deep down the left field line, twisting foul and out of play count, 0-2. Bortnick, on the second pitch of the ball game yesterday, he homered. That was kind of the way that the game transpired, set it off on the right track. 10 home runs combined between the two teams.
Yeah, it was the second pitch of the game. Fujisawa had, Aichi was the pitcher in yesterday's game, hadn't quite settled in.
0-2 offering, breaking ball swung on, grounded sharply over the glove of the diving second baseman Cruz. And make that Harmon goes into center field for a base hit. We're going to have to disconnect for just one moment. We'll come back with action from today's game.
Should be back here at the ballpark. Just had to adjust our audio volume real quick. We have one camera working today, so try to bear with us here. Runner on first, and Trent Olchin swings at the first pitch, drives it down the right field line for a base hit. And it's actually Olchin stopping, or make that Bortnick stopping at third. Olchin at second with a double, and just like that, back-to-back hits for the Blue Sox to begin the game. Bortnick a single, Olchin a double, brings runners at second and third, nobody out, in steps Josh Dean.
Sydney Blue Sox just taking off from where they left off yesterday, swinging the bats well. They hit the ball really hard yesterday, a lot of hard hit balls on fastballs, line drives, and there's two right there, Bortnick with a shot up the middle over the diving Harmon. Trent Olchin, former major leaguer, pulled that ball hard straight down the right field line into the corner for a double.
Back-to-back hits, Bortnick and Olchin on second and third respectively. Righty versus lefty, pitch to Deans, a breaking ball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. Josh Dean tied the ball game up yesterday with a solo home run in the ninth inning. This year hitting .345 with a home run and 9 RBIs. The 0-1 count, nobody out. Top of the first. A swung on, blooped, shallow right field coming on in. His Wern, ball hits off his thigh and bounces into the right center field. Gap Bortnick scores with ease. Rounding third from second is Olchin. He'll score. And Josh Dean will trot into second, likely given a single and an error. It is. But 2 runs scored. Just like that, Sydney up by a score of 2-0 with nobody out in the first.
Another hard hit ball, this time off the bat of Joshua Dean. Short hop, Scott Wern there in right field, playing right field tonight. Instead of Dylan Cousins, has been in right field all games so far. And yeah, bounced off the leg, shot across towards centre field. Allowed Joshua Dean to scamper up to second, scoring two, knocking in 2 runs.
2 runs aboard, brings up Alex Glenn, who swings at the first pitch, drives it Down the first base side, foul. Out of play, count 0-1. Glenn, a pinch hit two-run home run in the eighth inning yesterday sparked the second rally for Sydney. Glenn, one of six home runs hit by the Blue Sox, 10 combined in the ballgame. 0-1 count. Pitch from Godbolt, fastball, swung on and chopped foul down the first base side. Godbolt keeping the ball in the strike zone. Three hits so far for the Blue Sox, but he's gotten ahead. Glenn, count 0-2.
Yeah, just leaving too many pitches over the fat part of the plate at this stage, Godbolt. As I said, Sydney Blue Sox swung the bats well yesterday. Go right at it again here. After a series win, they are currently leading 2-1.
0-2 pitch. Fastball swung on and missed. Strike three. Big first out on the inning by Hayden Godbolt. Aces need a good start from him. Bullpen in a state of disarray.
Good fastball up high. Alex Glenn couldn't catch up with it. Sits down with a strikeout, first out.
In steps Will Swanner, who hit one of the six home runs yesterday for the Blue Sox. 196 on the season, two home runs, eight RBIs for the Colorado Rockies farmhand. Josh Dean stands on second after a two-run single. He advanced on an error. Righty versus righty, first pitch. It's taken on the outside corner for a strike. Count 0-1, Godbolt, a 22-year-old right-handed pitcher. Stands 180 centimeters, 83 kilograms, translates to 5 feet 11 inches and 180 pounds. The 0-1 offering from Godbolt. Breaking ball swung on and missed, strike two. 2-0 Blue Sox. We're in the top half of the first inning. One away. Bortnick and doubled, both scored on a two-run single by Josh Dean, who is on second now, with an error by right fielder Scott Wern. The 0-2 count. From the stretch, Godbolt the pitch. Breaking ball swung on, chopped towards third. Two hops to Davies. High hop fields. It fires over to first. High throw. Goes over the head of Deglan. Rolls down the right field line, but Deglan gets to it quickly. Dean holds up at third. So Will Swanner reaches on a throwing error from Josh Davies. That's the second error of the inning for the Aces. And our runners at first and third. Still just one out. I'll bring up Alex Ho.
Yeah, two hopper to Josh Davies. Usually really reliable there. Glove the ball, no problem. Just a high throw. Deglan couldn't get it. Went into foul territory. Runners on the corners now for the Blue Sox.
Howe steps in from the left side. Two hits in game two of this series. First pitch, righty versus lefties. A fastball that hits the outside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. First two games of the series for Sydney, they had six combined hits. Yesterday, they had 14 alone and 12 after the fifth inning. When it rains, it pours. Aces trail 2-0. Runners at first and third for the Blue Sox. 0-1 pitch is lined into right field for a base hit. So Dean scores from third, Swanner to second, and Alex Howe with an RBI single that has run batted in number two on the year. Blue Sox have run so far with just one out in the top half of the first inning.
Just the one away, pitching coach John Hussey out to the mound. Have a chat with Godbolt. Not the ideal start for this game. Aces really need to win this game. Beautiful conditions here, sun shining. Light breeze blowing, not as dramatic as last night. Balls flying out of this park, 10 in total in yesterday's game.
So meeting at the mound, we have Yaku Night Owl tuning in, per usual. Fans, if you are listening in, let us know. Tweet us at Voice of Cohen. That is at Voice of Cohen. And then at Fritta, F-R-I-T-A, 1-T, not 2, 51.
Thank you.
Just got to get your followers up. So one away, meeting at the mound finish. Brings up third baseman Zach Shepard. Had his first hit of the series yesterday. Go figure, a two-run home run. Righty versus righty. First pitch, fastball that hits the inside corner for a strike. Fallon 0-1. Swanner leading off of second. Howe off of first. Infield playing double play depth up the middle. Outfield playing Shepherd straight away. No balls, one strike. Pitch from Godbold, fastball that just misses inside. Count 1-1. Beautiful Sunday afternoon here at the ballpark. Bark in the park day. Blue Sox won game one of this series. Aces won game two. Blue Sox came from behind, won game three. 1-1 pitch. Overhand breaking ball that's taken just high. Crowd wanted that one. Count 2-1. Aces will travel next week back to Brisbane for their to Brisbane this season.
Yeah, unusual scheduling in this early stages of the season. Heading back to Brisbane.
Pitch grounded over toward short. This could be two. Cruise to second for one. Harmon back over to first. And the Aces turn the double play. Inning ending. 6-4-3. Twin killing stops the bleeding for a moment. But the Blue Sox score three runs. They do so on three hits, two errors, and one man left on base. Through a half an inning, Blue Sox up by a score of 3-0 here at Melbourne Ballpark. Aces tried to start the comeback trail here in the bottom half of the first. They're down 3-0. Top third of the Aces order, Engel, Numata, Harmon in to face the young lefty Lachlan Wells, who fires a first pitch fastball to the righty Engel. Called for a strike count 0-1. Engel hitting 152. No home runs, no had a hit in each of the last two games. A one offering fastball that's taken up high. Count 1-1, Lachlan Wells, born in 1997, meaning he's 17 years old.
Yeah, incredible.
Making his first appearance with the Blue Sox this year, 1-1 offering fastball that's taken up high. Count 2-1, just signed with the Minnesota Twins organization this past summer. Twins have a long list of Australian prospects in their minor league system. 2-1 offering fastball. Now back at the play, count 2-2.
Howie Norsetter, the Minnesota Twins scout, Southern Region, has really been prolific here in Australia. Was signing a number of guys, Nakamura, Grant Balfour, just a couple, Luke Hughes. There's been a number of, could rattle off a dozen names. This fresh one now, only 17, as you said, Lachlan Wells.
Hard-throwing lefty, 2-2 offering fastball, swung on and fouled back out of play. Bat goes flying into the Sydney dugout down the third base side. Count remains 2-2. Wells pitched for the under 21 Australian national team. actually struck out six in their signature win against Venezuela 2 weeks ago. So Wells still growing into his body.
Another Twins signing. Sam Gibbons has just signed on with the Aces. Will be part of the squad next weekend, I believe. It's from Geelong. Has pitched with the Aces before, but just recently signed back on with the Aces and will be part of it next week in Brisbane.
Two balls, two out, lefty versus righty. Pitch fastball that's taken up high. Count 3-2. Lachlan Wells, 185 centimeters, 80 kilograms. Payoff pitch, fastball that's taken up high, ball four, and Adam Engel draws a leadoff walk here in the first.
Yeah, you can see how the interest came from the Minnesota Twins towards Lachlan Wells. Good size, broad shoulders for his young age. He can really work on that frame once he starts lifting, and a good meat and potatoes diet. He really turned into some sort of specimen physically. Throws sharp now, overhand breaking ball. Little fade on his fastball, good movement.
Brings up Chase Numata, switch in and catcher standing in from the right side, takes a first. All up high, count 1-0. We saw yesterday how Engel could take control of the game with his speed. He reached first, I believe it was on a walk, then went to second on a wild pitch, stole third, and ultimately scored. Before the 1-0 pitch, throw back to first, and Engel dives in safely. Adam Engel, 7 stolen bases that leads the baseball league.
And missed the first series with a bye to the Aces, so 4 games behind anybody else, and is still leading the stolen bases. So tremendous speed.
1-0 pitch. Fastball swung on. Line into left field, but it's right at Howell who makes the catch. Takes a couple steps in. Glove-high grab. Retires Numata. Engel retreats back to first, and will bring up shortstop Brad Harmon. Defensive alignment for the Blue Sox. Olchin, Glenn, and left in the outfield. Right to left in the infield, Dean Lysart, Bortnick, Shepard, the catcher, Swanner. Brad Harmon steps to the plate, playing second base today. Stands in from the right side, and before the first pitch, Wells fires back to first. Engel slides in safely. Aces trailing by a score of 3-0. We're in the bottom of the first with one out. 4 hits on the inning for Sydney. Pitch to Harmon's taken up high.
So far, Wells has left a lot of pitches. Again, the Aces in this early stage is down 3-0 right now. Really need to be. He's only 17 years of age and can't quite find the zone right now. They need to be patient and make him work his way into the strike zone.
1-0 offering. Breaking ball swung on and missed strike one. Harmon coming into the game hitting .333 with 3 home runs. 5 RBIs yesterday, had his 8-game hitting streak to start off the season snapped. Tied for his career-long hitting streak set just last year. 1-1 offering, runner off on the pitch, fastball swung on and fouled back at the screen behind home plate. Aces manager Tommy Thompson trying to harp on that small ball mentality, and they tried it there.
Good aggression right there. Engel was off on the move, has to wait till the left-hander commits to the home plate, but then he was off. Harmon had a good swing on that pitch on the belt, fouled it straight back, just missed it.
1-1, 2 strikes. Breaking ball swung on, chopped over towards first, tough play. Dean gobbles it up, meets Harmon in the baseline. He's retired, but angled a second. So, 2 away. Runner in scoring position for the Aces. It brings up Kellin Deglan.
Hard-hitting Deglan, playing first base here today.
Deglan.
Sorry,
Fredo. Batting average up to .277 on the year. 4 home runs and a team-leading 12 RBIs. Second in the ABL.
Perfect conditions for a game of baseball. Sun shining. Adam Engel at second base, Kellin Deglan at bat.
Lefty versus pitch to Deglan. Fastball swung on and missed, some high heat from Wells. Count 0-1. Deglan a hit in each of the last 3 games, well, in this series. He's had two hits in each.
Yeah, he's been swinging the bats well. And, you know, we've talked about it this early stages of the season, how quickly they got thrown together just before opening day, this team.
A one offering. Angle off on the pitch. It's taken low. Almost gets away from the catcher. Swanery has no chance to get Angle. So just credit that. Eighth stolen base on the year.
Just going to say, up the list there, Engel really has tremendous speed, and any good is a mix of speed, power, good pitching.
1-1 offering fastball. That's taken up high. Count 2-1. Sydney, four hits in the first. They scored three runs. Headlined by a two-run single from Josh Dean. 3-0 ball game. 2-1 pitch. Fastball swung on. Right field, back is Olchin, and just in front of the scoreboard, he has room to put it away for a loud final out here in the first. Aces rally, do not score. No runs, no hits, no errors, and one man left on base at third. We're through one. Aces trailing by a score of 3-0 here at Melbourne Ballpark. I'm back here for the top half of the second inning. Aces trailing by a score of 3-0 in the finale of a four-game ballpark. It is Trent DeAntonio to lead off the inning. He takes a 1-0 fastball, a healthy hack, and he fouls it behind home plate, out of play. Count 1-1. In the first inning, single, double, two-run single, RBI single. Has damage for the Blue Sox. Godbold, the 1-1 pitch, fastball that's taken up high. Count 2-1. We have Lolly tuning in from Georgia, loving the ABL. Appreciate it, Lolly. 2-1 offering from Godbold. Fastball that's taken just outside. Count 3-1. Fans, if you are listening in, let us know. Tweet us at Voice of Cohen, at V-O-I-C-E of O-F. Cohen, C-O-H-E-N, and at Fritta, F-R-I-T-A 51. 3-1 offerings, a fastball that hits the outside corner for a strike on DeAntonio. That's a liberal outside corner call there. Gives Godbold the strike. Count now 3-2.
Just give a little shout-out to Ben Smith. Texted in, wanted to say good day. His young son, Curtis, listening to the broadcast.
3-2 offering. Fastball that's taken just inside. Might have been a bit high as well, as DeAntonio draws a leadoff walk here in the second. Steps second baseman Michael Lysart.
Explosive start in the first innings by Sydney Blue Sox, putting three on the board. Aces need a quick innings here. Just on balls, they've been swinging the bat of Sydney. As we mentioned, 10 home runs in total, both teams in the game last night. They need a couple of quick innings to the Aces, get in and swing the bats. Get back into this game.
Righty versus righty. First pitch from Godbold to Lysart. A breaking ball that's taken low. Count 1-0. Jet Couriers, Melbourne Aces, trailing by a score of 3-0. Here in the top half of the second inning, Trent DeAntonio leads off the inning with a walk, being held on by the first baseman, Deglan. Godbold working from the first base side of the rubber. 1-0 pitch fastball that hits the outside corner for a strike. Count 1-1. Lysart this season hitting 286 with a home run and 3 RBI. It's sparingly throughout the series. One ball, one strike as Godbold looks back to first. Diving in safely is DeAntonio. Hayden Godbold making his first start in an Aces uniform by the Aces during their open tryout 2 weeks before the season started. Pitched for a club team that faced the Sydney Blue Sox last year. 1-1 pitch, runner off, fastball swung on, driven deep down the left field line, but it will slice foul and out of play.
We did talk about it last night in yesterday's game with General Manager Windsor Knox, who talked about those open tryouts and what a great thing it was, and hopefully it will continue from years to come. There are a lot of good club players around and or imports that this National League don't know about. It gives them an opportunity to show their wares, and Thompson has selected a number of guys to be a part of the Aces this year. From those open tryouts, Godbold being one of them.
DeAntonio two-stride lead off of first, being held on by Deglan. The 1-2 offering, breaking ball swung on, chopped down the third base side, and foul backhanded by Deglan in foul territory. Count 1-2. More shout-outs. We have a dynamic duo tuning in San Francisco, California, Tessa and Erica. Both tuning in. Tessa was part of the triumphant trio yesterday tuning in, now the dynamic duo, so two listeners instead of three brings down our listenership. Oh man, appreciate you guys tuning in. The baseball capital of the world now, San Francisco. Those Giants, 3 World Series in 5 years.
Boy, and they've been terrific.
Must be nice. 1-2 pitch. Fastball swung on and foul back at the screen behind home plate. And I'll tell you, Fritta, you were in fielding position. If that screen wasn't there,
that ball was
either destined for your mitts or my face.
Yeah, it was. I was in the ready set position right there. I was ready for a ground ball. It was coming right in the window, I think.
Count remains 1-2. Nobody out. Top of the first. Aces trail 3-0. Pitch, breaking ball swung on, chop foul down the third base side into the Sydney dugout. Lysart and Godbold, quite a battle here between the starting pitcher and the 9-hole hitter for Sydney. Count remains 1-2. One-two offering, breaking ball, swung on and missed strike 3. So Hayden, second strikeout of the ball game, turns over the lineup card with one out. Here in the top of the second, it'll bring up Tyler.
Nice breaking ball at the outside edge. Looked like a little cut fastball, or in the old days, a slider. Now it's called cut fastball, very similar style of pitch. Slight differences, but very, very similar. Nice pitch outside corner. Sits.
Bortnick stands in from the right side. First pitch from Godbold's a fastball. Taken on the outside corner for a strike. Throw down back to first by Numata to try to get the runner, not in time. Bortnick to lead off the game. Singled and scored. Hitting 276 with 2 home runs and 8 RBIs. Actually missed game 2 of this series. Was feeling a bit under the weather.
Yes, that happens when you travel, eating different foods. Of course, some of these around the world.
Godbold from the stretch. 0-1 pitch, breaking ball that's taken low. Count 1-1. Bortnick, a U.S. import, has played for both the Rays organization and the Diamondbacks organization. Reached AAA in both levels in the International League with Durham and also the PCL with Reno. 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball swung on, chop foul down the third base side. Count 1-2.
I like that attempted pickoff there from Chase Numata. The Aces need to look for some cheap outs however they can. They do not want to continue Sydney just put base runners on as they please. They've hit the ball hard this early stage. Base on balls. Need to try and get some cheap outs. If that be throw back behind a runner, get a cheap out, they need to do it.
Guard ball, chest high set, 1-2 pitch. Fastball swung on line into center field. Angle, nice beat on it, makes the catch. Taking 5 steps into the right center field gap. He puts away Bortnik. D'Antonio, first two away. Godbolt settling down, and will bring up Trent Olchin.
A couple of hard hit balls from Bortnik there. First at bat was a line drive back up the middle. Again, another line drive. This one carried in the air to Adam Engel for the second out. Gives Trent D'Antonio, stays at first base, and brings to bat Trent Olchin.
Olchin coming into the game hitting .327 with 4 home runs and 12 RBIs. Hit a home run in last night's game and in game one of this series. Former big leaguer in both the Diamondbacks organization and the Dodgers organization. Righty versus lefty, first pitch. Fastball swung on, rolled over sharply to second. At Harmon picks it up, fires over to first, and retires Olchin in plenty of time for the final out here in the second. Godbolt settles down, a scoreless frame. No runs, no hits, no errors. One man left on base. Middle of two. Aces trailing by a score of 3-0 here at Melbourne Ballpark. Bottom half of the second inning, Aces down by a score of 3-0. Alex Cohen and Craig Kernick on the call. Fritta, bring up Josh Davies to begin the inning. Lefty versus righty, first pitch. Taken on the inside corner for a strike. Count on 1. Davies, featured on the Aces website. Alexis Bernicki with a great story on Davies. Check it out on the website. 3 hits yesterday, 1-1 pitch. Fastball swung on and fisted foul.
Yeah, Alexis has done a couple of great stories. Aaron Sayers was in there, Josh Davies yesterday, and maybe the players wait till they get a story written about him, have a day out with a bat.
They're going to get a story written about me.
It's no good you getting a hit up here, though. No good.
1-2 pitch, fastball swung on and foul back behind home plate. Count 1-2, Davies pitched in the States while back with the organization as well as the Padres, both hit and pitched. The 1-2 offering. Fastball that's taken up high. Count 2-2. Been very impressed with the youngster Lachlan Wells on the mound so far for Sydney.
Yeah, he is leaving a few pitches up, but he will work into that. This is just a young man getting his release point.
2-2 offering. Breaking ball swung on and bounced back behind home plate, foul.
He looks to have a little fade on his pitch, just at the release point. In the old days, called a screwball, but it's not literally a screwball. Just fades that ball right to the outside edge of the plate, throws it to the edge, and ends up off the plate.
2-2 pitch, fastball swung on and missed strike 3. So, Lachlan Wells with a strikeout of Josh Davies here to begin. Pick up Scott Wern.
Wern playing right field tonight. Been all over the place. Was left field the other day. Played some second base earlier in the season. Playing right field tonight.
Lefty versus lefty. First pitch from Wells. Fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. Warren hitting 212 on the year with no home runs, three RBIs. 0-1 offering. Breaking ball that's taken outside. Count 1-1. We have Itchy and Mitchy tuning in. Go Blue Sox. Ugh.
Yeah.
1-1 just, pitch.
Just break. Read that out once.
Go Blue Sox?
Just wait.
Well, now I've read it twice.
Okay.
Warren swings through a breaking ball. Count 1-2. Wells from the windup. The 1-2 pitch. Check swing and a high fastball. Warren does not go around. Count 2-2. Fans, if you are listening in, let us know. Tweet us at Voice of Cohen, at Fritta, 1T, not 2T's, 51. Got a 2-2 pitch, and he lines it sharply to first. Dean takes it on a hop, takes it over to first himself. It retires Wern. Two up, two down for Lachlan Wells in the second. A brander, Justin Huber.
Ball hit sharply from Wern. Well handled it at first base by Joshua Dean. Took the play himself to retire Wern.
Huber swings at the first pitch, sends it deep to center field. Back is Glenn waiting underneath it. He makes the catch. A long, loud final out here in the second. Lachlan Wells sends down the aces in order. No runs, no hits, no errors, no man left on base through two. By a score of 3-0 here at Melbourne Ballpark. Top half of the third inning, Hayden Godbold, after giving up three runs in the first, settled down in the second. Scoreless frame, he will see Dean, Glenn, and Swanner 3-4-5. Red hot as of late, takes a first pitch fastball on the inside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. Dean, two-run single in the first, homered and doubled yesterday, hitting 345 on the year with a home run and nine RBIs. Fourth in the ABL in hitting, 0-1 pitch. Fastball swung on ground, a sharply passed first baseman Deglan, and into right base hit. So Dean locked and loaded. 2-for-2 today, leadoff base runner in the third for the Blue Sox, and will bring up center fielder Alex Glenn.
Alex, first time round, came in a pinch hit in that game yesterday. Hit one of the 10 home runs, the one that tied it up in the ninth. Long, long home run over the scoreboard in right field.
Wind blowing out yesterday, not so much today. Blowing a touch in. Glenn stands in from the left side, righty versus lefty. First pitch fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. Godbold working from the first base side of the rubber. Glove up by his chin from the stretch, looking back at pitch. Fastball swung on, grounded sharply to second underneath the glove of Harmon and into right field. Warren gets it quickly, throws it in towards second. Ball gets by him, and Davies, the third baseman backing up, gets it. That should be ruled a hit on a hard hit ball, but one that Harmon usually gets. That's a tough error.
That was a tough error. A hard hit ball to the glove side of Harmon, went across to try and get it. Ended up shooting under him off the carpet. Goes down as E4.
That's the third error on the ball game by the Aces defense so far. Ouch.
Yeah.
On first and second with nobody out. In stepped Swatter, who reached on an error in the first. Righty versus righty. Godbold looking back at second at Dean being held on by Cruz. Swanner squares around to bunt at a fastball. He pulls back, and some high heat from Godbold taken for a ball. Count 1-0.
There's some intent right there from the Sydney Blue Sox trying to bunt this run across, holding a 3-0 lead over the Jet Couriers Melbourne Aces at this stage. Runner on second, runner on first. Going to bunt them across, hopefully. Showing some intent to really try and get some runs on the board early.
Cruz holding on Dean at second, 1-0 pitch. Fastball that once again is taken up high. Count 2-0. Aces trailing 3-0. Dating back to yesterday's ball game, Fritta, the Blue Sox in their last 8 innings have scored 11 unanswered runs.
Yeah, they've been terrific, as I mentioned earlier. They've really hit the ball hard. They're jumping on fastballs, seem to be laying off breaking balls a lot of the time.
2-0 delivery. Fastball waved at and missed strike one. Surprised to see Swanner swinging on a 2-0 pitch.
Yeah, but they've really been jumping all over fastballs, getting a fastball I can handle and hitting it hard. That's the key. Doesn't matter what sort of pitch you end up seeing. If you can hit the ball hard somewhere, that's the key to baseball. They'll drop for you eventually. The Sydney Blue Sox have been doing that in the last two games. They've swung the bats really well, hit the fastball hard.
2-1 count. Godbold looking back at second, fires towards the plate. A fastball swung on, a missed strike two. So Godbold working backwards, down in the count 2-0. Two swinging strikes to Swanner. Say that five times fast.
Yeah.
Brings it back to two balls and two strikes. Nobody out, top of the third. Aces trailing 3-0. No hits so far for the Aces. Only thing on their scoreboard, three errors. From the stretch, 2-2 pitch. Fastball swung on and driven. Medium depth right center field. Angle underneath it, and he makes the catch. Holds the runner at second. Dean stays there. One away in the third. And that'll bring up left fielder Alex Howe.
Big pop-up off the bat there of Will Swanner. Adam Engel had to cruise in, had plenty of time to get under it. We've talked about his speed season. Tremendous speed out there in center field. Easily camps under it, makes a fine catch.
Howe, RBI single in the first. Caught yesterday, has played right field and left field this series as well. Utility player. Right first pitch, fastball that's flared into left field. Hendricks coming on, and he makes the catch. It's on the sinking line drive. Made the catch by his shoe tops. That was close, but one pitch, one out here to Howe. And Godbold, after allowing the first two batters to reach base, two consecutive outs.
Yeah, end up being a shoestringer in the end. Hendricks, again, cruising into the ball off the left-hander's bat, was curling towards the left-field line, ended up really dying. The wind knocked it down. Hendricks having to catch it off the top of his boots, made the catch in the end, two out.
Zach Shepherd steps up, grounded into an inning-ending 6-4-3 double play in the first. Righty versus righty, first is taken outside. Count 1-0. Sydney with three runs on five hits, but four of them came in the first. That is four hits, and all three runs came in the first. Top of the third inning. 1-0 pitch. Fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike against the right-hand hitting third baseman, who also made an appearance on the U21 Australian national team. A lot of players represented on that team in this game. Shepard, Wells, Jared Cruz, Aaron Sayers on the bench for the Aces. 1-1 pitch. Ball that's taken on the outside corner for a strikeout. 1-2. Shepard not pleased. He thought that was high, and I'm not sure I blame him.
Yeah, there's been some pitches up high, above the belt. Usually strike zone tends to be about the belt. One looked to be maybe a touch high, but called strike.
Got an eyes-to-thighs strike zone. 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball that's taken in the dirt. Not called for a strike. Count even at 2. Nice crowd in attendance here at Melbourne Ballpark. Bark in the park day. And I don't see that many dogs right now. There are some down the third base side. 2-2 pitch. Fastball that's taken low. Count 3-2. Always love Bark in the park, especially with the treats that they get at the end of the game.
Absolutely. I did see one cheeky bugger I'll call in. They had a cat dressed as a dog.
Cheeky bugger?
Cheeky bugger. It's okay. There's nothing nasty. It's
might
okay.
Might need a thesaurus on that one.
You need the Australian thesaurus.
AustralianDictionary.com. That could work.
Cheeky bugger is fine.
3-2. This will be off on the pitch. Fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a called third strike. And that will end the inning. So Zach Shepard goes down looking. Third strike out of the ball game. And Godbold in another scoreless frame. No runs, one hit, one error, and two men left on base. Middle of 3. Aces trailing by a score of 3-0 here at Melbourne Ballpark. Bottom of the third inning. Aces trailing by a score of 3-0. Josh Hendricks leading off the inning for the Aces. He swings at the first pitch and lines it into left field for a base hit. First hit on the ball game for the Aces, and Josh Hendricks, who has really played well in limited duty. That's his 7th hit and 17 at-bats.
Yeah, he's been a great pickup. Came on board with the Aces when they traveled up to Brisbane last week. Missed the first series, but came on last series to Brisbane. Has really swung the bats well. Him and Harmon have been the shining lights in this team.
Brings Cruz, who squares around to bunt at the first pitch from Wells. He pulls back at a fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike. Cal 0-1, Cruz. Playing in his third game with the Aces. He's had a hit in the first two. Lefty versus righty. 0-1 pitch fastball that's taken up high. Count 1-1. We will have a guest in the booth for the fourth and possibly the fifth inning, a member of the Aces media department, Mitch Keller. He's got a great radio voice. 1-1 pitch. Change up swung on and miss. Strike 2.
And a good head for radio.
Great face for radio. We all do, though.
Absolutely.
offering. Fastball, let's take it up high. Count 2-2. Aces with no runs on a hit. Just came a moment ago. Josh Hendricks with a single. Three errors. Sydney, three runs all in the first on five hits. 2-2 pitch. Fastball swung on and flared down the right field line. Fouling out of play. Count 2-2. Aces will hit the road on Friday, not Thursday, for four games in 3 days. Two single games and a doubleheader. Scheduled doubleheaders for it are always fun.
Yeah, they're always fun.
Fastball, that's taken up high. Count 3-2. One camera stream today, but plenty of audio from Alex and Fritta.
Always a treat.
Sounds like a story, like a movie. 3-2 pitch. Fastball swung on and foul. Stream behind home plate. Count remains 3-2. Jared Cruz said, last inning, member of the Australian U21 national team, and that obviously hasn't changed in the last inning or so. Four at-bats with the Aces last season. Before the 3-2 pitch, Wells fires over to first. Hendricks jumps in safely. Aces wearing their red jersey tops, white pants. Blue caps. Sydney wearing their blue shirts, white pants with a blue stripe down the side. 3-2 pitch is another fastball swung on and fouled back at the screen behind home plate. Wells and the nine-hole hitter Cruz in quite a battle right now.
Yeah, teammates recently, as you mentioned, over in Taiwan. A real battle just to see who's the better, best young pitcher.
3-2 pitch. Now a breaking ball swung on and missed. Foul back at the screen. Excuse me, swung on and foul back at the screen. He didn't miss. The ninth pitch of the at-bat on coming. 3-2 count. Bottom of the third, Aces trailing by of 3-0. Game four of a four-game set. 3-2 pitch. Fastball that's taken up high. Ball four. And quite the at-bat there from Jared Cruz. Aces have runners at first and second. Nobody out for the top of the order and Adam Engel.
Yeah, nice at-bat there from Jared Cruz. Is that patience you need to really consider against such a young arm? Lachlan Wells, only 17. Need to take your time, and he has left a number of pitches up high. So these hitters need to be patient, take their time, some long at-bats. Try and get into the arm and into the head of Lachlan Wells.
Lefty versus righty. First pitch, Engel squares around to bunt, pulls back at a fastball that's taken up high. Throw down to second to try to catch Hendricks off guard. Was a strong throw made by Swanner, but not in time to get Hendricks.
It was a great throw. Josh Hendricks was just been a little lazy out there. Swanner thought he'd keep him honest. Fired up to second base, not in time though.
Lefty versus righty from the stretch. Wells. Pitch, Engel squares around to bunt, pops it up as Wells dives, can't get to it. Ball hits off his glove and bounces into foul territory, but everybody's safe. So Hendricks moves up to third, Cruz to second, and they will likely give Adam Engel a bunt single on that. They should. They do. And now the Aces have the bases loaded. Crowd getting into it as the Aces PA announcer Gilly really getting the fans.
Yeah, it's a nice crowd here today considering the normal domestic competition is on today for baseball here in Victoria. So a lot of players and family are off at their respective clubs, but a nice crowd in.
Bases loaded, full of aces. Nobody out, brings up Chase Numata, lefty versus righty. First pitch is taken inside. Count 1-0, and you almost like to think that Numata would just turn the backside around and take a hit by a pitch, get the aces on the board. Easier said than done.
Yeah, absolutely.
1-0 pitch. Fastball swung on line right at the second baseman, Lystar. Look what I found. Makes the catch. But everybody retreats back to their respective bags. Hendricks at third, Cruz at second, Engel at first. One out will bring up Brad Harmon.
There really is just not a lot going for the Aces. in this series and in this season to this point. That ball's hit right on the nose by Chase Numata to the left-hand side of Michael Lysaught's second base. Cruised across it. A fairly simple catch, but the ball was hit right on the nose. Heads up running by all runners concerned, getting back to their bags.
Most dangerous hitter in the Aces lineup, Brad Harmon steps to the plate, takes a first pitch breaking ball low, count 1-0. Grounded into a fielder's choice in his last at bat, three unassisted. Aces down 3-0, bottom half of the third, one out with the bases loaded. Hendricks at third, Cruz at second, Engel at first. All three can move well. 1-0 pitch, another breaking ball from the lefty. Wells is taken low. Count 2-0.
You wouldn't want the bat in anybody else's hands but Brad Harmon right now. Way to get back in this game. He has been swinging the bat extremely well the last few games.
The 2-0 delivery. Fastball swung on, popped up. Swanner can't find it, throws up his hands, but the ball goes behind him and well out of play behind home plate.
Well out of play. There was a chance for Harmon right there. Fastball on the belt, inside part of the plate. Really turned on it hard, trying to get the head of the bat through. Just come up on the hands. It was a good fastball from Lachlan Wells. Got in on Harmon. Jammed him.
From the stretch, Wells. Lefty versus righty. 2-1 pitch. Fastball that's taken on the outer edge for a strike. Count 2-2, and you have to give Wells credit attacking the zone right there on a hitter's count, blowing a fastball by Harmon.
He doesn't seem intimidated by anybody. You mentioned just 17 years of age. Hasn't even got his license yet.
1997 he was born. I remember 1997.
Do you? I don't.
2-2 pitch. Check swing and a high fastball, and Harmon does not go around. Count 3-2. You don't remember 1997?
I don't remember yesterday.
I don't remember what I ate for breakfast. You know why? Because I didn't eat breakfast.
I got issues, mate. I got issues.
3-2 pitch. Fastball that swung on flare down the right field line, fouling out of play. Count remains 3-2. Harmon, the Aces three hitter for really the entire season to this point. Aces missing their cleanup hitter, middle of the order hitter, Dylan. His first game off of the 2014-2015 ABL season. Three balls, two strikes, one out. Payoff pitch. Fastball swung on. Line down the right field line. If it's fair, it's trouble. And Olchin doesn't have room because this ball goes foul and bounces out of play.
That's something they needed. This would have been a bit of luck right there. It was really looking like going right in the corner. The breeze today, right-handed hitting Harmon, punching it down the right field line. Ended up curling just foul, probably by about 5 or 6 feet in the end. A real chance there, just missed off the bat of Brad Harmon. Bases still loaded here, bottom of the third innings. Sydney Blue Sox holding a 3-0 lead at this stage.
Wells versus Harmon, a battle with the bases loaded. Payoff pitch, fastball that's taken up high, ball four. So Brad Harmon draws an 8-pitch bases loaded walk. It brings in Josh Hendricks, and it puts the Aces on the board. They're down by a score of 3-1 here in the bottom half of the third.
Yeah, they needed on the board as pitching coach for the Blue Sox coming out to have a chat with the young Lachlan Wells. First run on the board there for the Aces. Doesn't always have to be a smashing line drive into a gap. It's a really important walk drawn there by Brad Harmon to get Aces on the board with their first run. Now 3-1 lead held by the Blue Sox. Conversation is over on the mound. Lachlan Wells stays.
Big spot for the young lefty. A couple shout-outs before the break. I have to give a shout-out to my dad listening in. He was tuning in at 3:30 in the morning Eastern time.
They seem real fans
and
of the
right
game.
Right back up, they are.
It can't be they like you. Okay.
Definitely
not. Couldn't be.
Also, Veronica Jensen tuning in, also from San Francisco, California. Veronica, pretty name.
Absolutely.
Lefty versus lefty. First pitch, breaking ball, swung on, chopped to first. Dean bobbles it, but will take it over to first himself. Retired Deglan, but with the bases loaded, all the runners advance, which means Cruz scores. Engel to third, Harmon to second, and RBI ground out by Kellin Deglan. 13th run batted in on the year. Aces just trailing by one now with two outs in the bottom of the third.
The run comes in there and on a ground ball hit by Deglan. I just wish he had been a little more patient. There's at times there need to be patient with a young Wells who's just been spoken to by the pitching coach, just walked Brad Harmon, as time's been called. He's just got Harmon at second base, got some dirt in the eye, just trying to clear the eye. But I just wish Deglan, and this all comes with experience, you just can't punch experience into young players, young athletes. If he had just taken a few pitches, he might have drawn a walk himself.
I'm going to play devil's advocate here.
Yeah, yeah.
Having a pitcher come up, just walk the guy with the bases loaded, you would think that he might groove a fastball down the middle.
Yeah, might do. Lachlan Wells has left a lot of balls up.
Deglan saw red, hit red, and ended up driving in a run in the process. But now two outs, so one count to Josh Davies with runners at second and third. Aces now trail 3-2, 0-1 pitch fastball.
Three 2 lead to the Blue Sox. Runners in scoring position. Harmon at second.
Angle on third. The 1-1 offering from Wells. Fastball swung on and foul back at the screen behind home plate. Count 1-2. Davies struck out in his first at bat. Batting average up to 308 on the year. Two home runs, 8 RBIs. Hit a 2-run blast yesterday into the left center field gap. 1-2, 2-2. Wells from the stretch fires a breaking ball that's taken in the dirt. It's a nice stop by Swanner with a runner on third in Engel. That ball gets by him. We could have a tie game.
Yeah, there was a nice piece of blocking there by Will Swanner. Got down on his knees and knocked it at his feet. Could easily have got away and Engel scores, but nice piece of catching.
2-2 offering. Breaking ball, swung on and missed strike three. So Wells gets out of a bit of a jam, but not before he gives two runs back. Two runs, no errors, two men left on base after three. Aces coming back, trailing by a score of 3-2 here at Melbourne Ballpark. Top half of the fourth inning, Aces got two in the bottom half of the third. They're trailing by a score of 3-2. Hayden Gobbold, who has settled down, he will see D'Antonio, Lysart, and Bortnick. 8-9-1 as D'Antonio takes a first pitch high. Count 1-0. Guest in the booth, Mitch Keller, jack of all trades extraordinaire with the Melbourne Aces media department. Welcome, Mitch.
Thanks for having me, Alex.
Can't you hear that voice? So deep. 1-0 pitch, fastball that's taken low. Nice and a face for radio, Mitch, your first time aboard and really done a lot for the Aces this season.
Perfect in the booth, Al.
2-0 fastball that hits the outside corner for a strike against the left hand hitting D'Antonio. Count 2-1. Quite a game last night, 10 combined home runs, and I don't think one of them was a wall scraper. 2-1 offering. Fastball, that's count 3-1.
It's the type of stadium that it is not too deep to center, to right, or to left. Balls will fly out, especially when the wind's blown out. And it was yesterday, and it was flying.
3-1 pitch from Godbold. Fastball that's taken up high, ball four, and he walks D'Antonio just like he did to begin the second inning. Leadoff walk in the fourth inning will bring up Michael Lysart. Well, you're talking about the dimensions, Mitch. It's 300 feet down the left field line, down the right field line, 370 to dead center. So small dimensions, but with the wind blowing in like it is today, very difficult to hit a home run. Wind blowing out like it is yesterday, well, it's pretty simple to hit a home run.
Pretty brisk today, too. We had a lot of humidity and heat. Ball really flew off the bat yesterday. Going to be different today.
Instead, pitch, righty versus righty. A fastball swung on and missed strike one. Mitch hailing from the States, the good old fine state of Wisconsin, the cheese.
Came born and bred out of Milwaukee. Cheese, their beer, and they're Milwaukee Brewers. So I'm happy to be here watching some baseball. Beautiful park and a beautiful day today.
You'll one pitch. Check swing at a breaking ball, and Lysart does go around. Nice. Mata. Count 0-2. Mitch, a Green Bay Packers and Milwaukee Brewers fan. Green Bay Packers had a decent win against my Philadelphia Eagles. And the Milwaukee Brewers, unfortunately, with a sizable collapse in the NL Central standings this year.
They didn't do so hot, but hey, we got Aaron Rodgers in the state for our football, so we're doing okay. We're looking forward to next year for baseball. Ron Renick, he's got a good crew. I think he's going to turn it around.
The 0-2 pitch, fastball, swung on, driven, right center field gap. Engel and Wern both chasing. It's Engel that calls off the right fielder. He makes the catch. Play here in the first as D'Antonio retreats back to the back. One out in the fourth. D'Antonio retreats back to first, and that'll turn over the lineup card and bring up shortstop Tyler Bortnick.
Looked like one of the cleaner fly balls we've seen field today. With the wind blowing around, there's been some odd jumps, some odd hops. Adam Engel well under that one, makes the out. Just one of those days with the wind. You got to make sure you're under it, and when you're closing out, it hits the ground, make sure.
Baseball fundamentals 101. Bortnick stands in from the right side. First pitch, breaking ball that's taken in the dirt. Nice stop by Numata, with D'Antonio threatening to go from first to second, stays there. Count 1-0.
The Aces have been worried about the runners today. You see Gombold check a few times. Numata has also thrown down to first as well. In a one-run lead, you're going to want to make sure that guy isn't going anywhere very quick.
Righty versus righty. Gombold from the stretch fires a pitch fastball that's taken on the inside corner for a strike. Count 1-1. We talked about it earlier, but Mitch, you were here for the Aces Open Tryout. Hayden Godbolt, a member of that Open Tryout, makes the team. Aces also have a couple players on their 40-man roster. Sam Moon, Andrew Chesterton, Marco Lazaic, who were picked up in that Open Tryout. 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball swung on. Pop side foul territory. No man's land. Wern coming in, chased by Harmon, and the ball lands in foul territory in the Bermuda Triangle out there. 1-2.
Good hustle by all three fielders getting over there. Just a ball that was not playable to make an out. And going back to those tryouts, something interesting, something as a front office, we thought we'll give it a shot. We'll see if we get any talent. Club ball is really deep here. And it just so happened that we had three pretty quality guys, and maybe even more than that, who ended up making this team and are still in contact talking to Tommy Thompson. Still may see some playing time this year.
Godbold, one of them. On the mound here for his first start in an Aces uniform. Top of the fourth. 3-2 ball game. Aces trail. 1-2 pitch. Taken on the inside corner for a called third strike. A heater freezes Bortnick, who turns his back and will now walk back to the dugout. That is strikeout number 4 on the ball game for Hayden Godbold. Two away here in the fourth. They'll bring up Trent Olchin.
Godbold has looked good at times after that first inning. Gave up the three runs, but it looks like he's settled in quite a bit. He's thrown a few strikes. Definitely had some strikeouts. That error behind him back in the third, but he looks like he's going well now.
Olchin, former big leaguer, doubled and scored in the first. Big test for Godbold, who from the stretch fires a fastball that's taken low. Count 1-0. We have some more listeners tuning in from the States. The grandparents tuning in from Boynton Beach, Florida. Thought it would be past their bedtime. Apparently not. Party animals at the age of, well, I'll say the mid-70s. We'll give them credit. They look a lot younger than that. 1-0 pitch. Fastball that's taken on the inside corner for a strike count. 1-1 also from the Chicagoland area. The Windy City. The family as well as Miss Michelle Ratner tuning in. Chicago, great city, good pizza, overrated sports. We'll leave it at that. 1-1 pitch. Fastball swung on, driven deep down the left field line, fouling out of play.
I've spent a fair amount of time in Chicago. I can vouch for it. However, once we start talking Cubs, Sox, and Bears, I'm out of the conversation.
We might have to mute you for that one.
Might have to turn me off. You don't want to hear what I have to say on this broadcast.
Well, the Aces have a couple of Chicago White Sox farmhands in Adam Engel and Nick Blunt, as well as a Chicago White Sox-affiliated manager in Tommy Thompson, so we might have to discuss it. We'll mute you. We'll turn you down low.
Just turn me down a little bit.
Two outs, top of the fourth, runner on first. Aces trailing by a score of 3-2. Godbolt from the stretch, pitch, fastball that hits the outside corner for a called third strike. Olchin not pleasing Hayden Godbolt. Two strikeouts in the inning, including a K of a former big leaguer to end the frame. Three consecutive scoreless innings for Godbolt after a three-run first. No runs, no hits, no errors. One man left on base, middle of four. Aces trailing by a score of 3-2. Bottom half of the fourth inning, Aces trailing by a score of 3-2. They tacked on three runs in the third. RBI ground out by Kellin Deglan. RBI bases loaded walk by Brad Harmon. Scott Wern swings at the first pitch from Lachlan Wells and fouls it behind home plate, out of play. Count 0-1, Alex Cohen and Mitch Keller on the call. I was about to call you Mitch Kramer, the character from Dazed and Confused. One of my favorite movies, by the way.
One of mine as well.
A one pitch. Fastball swung on and missed, strike two, making his debut in the broadcast booth, doing a lot for the Aces organization. Anything from writing post-game stories to doing the music. 0-2 pitch, breaking ball that's taken up high. Count 1-2, and last, taking out the trash with the rest of the Aces staff.
We're definitely all very talented garbage custodians on the 1-2 pitch outside for Wern. We get our hands dirty, but, you know, that's the nature of taking care of a ballpark and taking care of a baseball team. Everybody's all hands on deck.
Two balls, two strikes. Pitch, breaking ball, swung on and missed, strike three. Wern down on strikes, and Lachlan Wells, the 17-year-old, has been awfully impressive so far here today.
You can see him. He's not a big guy out there, but he has a great delivery. He's had great movement on his ball, all of his thrown balls so far today. You can see the Aces have tried to be aggressive and have done a lot of first pitch swinging, very opposite of what Sydney's been doing on the other side of the diamond.
Brings up the former big leaguer Justin Huber. Lefty versus righty, first pitch fastball that's taken right down the middle for a strike. Count 0-1. Huber was probably playing in the minors when Wells was born in 1997. Not quite. 0-1 pitch. Breaking ball that's taken inside. Count 1-1. Huber was in affiliated baseball in 2001. His first season. 1-1 offering. Changeup that's taken. Count 2-1, Justin Huber, a three-time member, well, really competitor, in the Futures game for the World Team. That must be fun. 2-1 offering. Fastball swung on and missed strike two. Huber still trying to get that back speed back, just his first series with the Aces this season.
He was out of baseball a while in the offseason. He had a few weeks off to enjoy his honeymoon, and we congratulate him on that. And now you can see he's slowly getting back into it as the 2-2 pitch comes.
Breaking ball swung on, chop right back at Wells, who leaps, makes the one-hop grab, throws over to first, and retires Huber on a hard hit ball. Two up, two down in the fourth. That will bring up Josh Hendricks.
Wells has been agile off the hill. That was a great play for him. He's the type I can tell his pants are kind of burrowing up on the bottom. He is not big, but he is quick. He is smart. He hides the ball well before he throws it.
First pitch to Hendricks, a fastball that's taken corner to the right-hand hitting outfielder. Count 0-1, Hendricks started off the two-run third inning with the single. Ultimately scored. He swings at an 0-1 pitch, lofts it down the right field line, fouling out of play. Count 0-2. He does not appear to be 17 years old on the mound.
No, he doesn't. He looks like a veteran out there, in all honesty. He's been fooling Aces hitters for the most part, with the exception of a few runs and hits.
0-2 pitch, waist fastball that's taken up high. Count 1-2. Aces trying to even up this series, come away with it with a split, two games apiece. 1-2 pitch, fastball swung on and fouled behind home plate.
You got to admire Wells' composure as well, too. He has not changed his consistency at all. He's been quick on the mound, quick to make the throw. Doesn't look like he's been rattled even after that two-run third inning.
Same tempo. 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball swung on, cute foul down the third base side as Hendricks was a bit out in front. Count 1-2. Lachlan Wells a strike and an out away from a 1-2-3 inning here in the bottom of the fourth. Aces down by a score of 3-2. We're down 3-0 after the first inning, but a two-run third has brought them back within one. 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball and a beauty taken on the inside corner for a called third strike. And Lachlan Wells cruising. Three up, three down here in the fourth. No runs, no hits, no errors, no men left on base. After four, Aces trailing by a score of 3-2 here at Melbourne Ballpark. Top half of the fifth inning. A couple young pitchers really battling today. Hayden Godbold for the Aces. And Lachlan Wells for Sydney. Godbold, he will see Joshua Dean to begin the frame. Dean, two hits already today. Righty versus lefty, first pitch fastball that's taken inside. Count 1-0. Dean, two-run single in the first. Also singled in the third. Homered yesterday. Well, the 1-0 offering. Fastball that's taken on the outer edge for a strike. Count 1-1. Aces will head back to Brisbane on Friday. Second trip to Brisbane already this season. Interesting how the schedule made that trip. 1-1 offerings, a changeup that's taken low. Count 2-1.
You hope to see some familiarity out of the bullpen, especially with the hitters going back to Brisbane from Melbourne. Had a tough two series against the Bandits, but they're looking to go back. Maybe weather will be a little more tame, a little more behaved, and they can get some wins out there.
The 2-1 offering. On yank down the right field line. If it's Well, it will slice foul and one hop over the wall, so just a long strike. Count 2-2, and talking about those series with Brisbane, 8 games, 6 of them decided by one run, and the Aces lost 4 of them. So they're right in it. They turn around a couple of those games. They go 4-2 in one-run games instead of 2-4. You're looking at a much different team.
And we're looking at a series now with Sydney that's seen a lot of the same. Games that are very close are kind of decided in the last few innings, or at least by one or two innings. Pitching has been a problem deep in the games for the Aces, but they're looking to figure that out. Godbold trying to go as many innings as he can today.
2-2 offering. Fastball that is taken just high, count 3-2. Aces bullpen a bit decimated after 11 innings yesterday. Tim Brown got the blown save. Matt Wilson threw an inning and 2/3. And John Kennedy, newcomer for the Aces, fresh off the U21 national team, got the loss. 3-2 pitch. Fastball swung on and missed strike 3. Hayden Godbold, 3 consecutive strikeouts dating back to the 4th inning. That's strikeout number 6 on the game in total. And now with one out in the 5th, they'll bring up Alex Glenn. Aces down by a score of 3-2.
Glenn's a guy you don't want to get comfortable against. He will hit it out. He did it yesterday in a pinch hit.
That came in the 8th inning. Righty versus lefty. Pitch from Godbold. Breaking ball that's taken inside. Count 1-0. Aces with their 2-run inning. It's snapped and 11-run unanswered streak for Sydney dating back to yesterday's ballgame. 1-0 pitch. Fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike. Count 1-1. No action in either bullpen. We're in the 5th. Aces down by a score of 3-2. Alex Cohen and Mitch Keller on the call. 1-1 offering. Fastball swung on and missed strike 2. You look at Glenn's swing. Not a big guy, but violent. Back foot. All his weight there and basically seeing a fastball and swinging as hard as he possibly can at it.
He stands tall in the box, and then when that ball comes in, he bends the knees. You can tell he's trying to generate a lot of power to the pull field.
1-2 pitch. Fastball swung on, grounded sharply in between the hole at first and second. Goes into right field for a base hit. So Alex Glenn, a one-out base runner here for the Blue Sox in the 5th. And I'll bring up catcher Will Swanner.
You can assume the Aces, and Tommy's staff here is going to keep a close eye on Glenn. He's not someone who's stolen a lot of bases this year, but he will make a run for it. Aces have been pretty watchful over the first base all game. I think Hayden Godbold throws over at least once or twice if we get a long at-bat here.
Swanner reached on an error in the first. He flew out to center in the 3rd. First pitch, fastball swung on and down the 3rd base side. Foul count 0-1. We have Amanda Bennett tuning in, as well as Stuart McMillan with the webcast. St. Louis Cardinals hat making its appearance in the shot. Big Cam, the former Sydney Blue Sox voice, letting us know that Hayden Godbold played in the Sydney State League the last couple years before moving south. Appreciate it, Big Cam. Strike, one out, runner on first. Alex Glenn here in the top of the 5th. From the stretch, Godbold fires a breaking ball, swung on and fouled back at the screen behind home plate. Count 0-2, we said this a couple times this series, Mitch, but Swanner, this past season, played with the Tulsa Drillers, AA affiliate for the Rockies, with former Melbourne Aces player and ex-ABL MVP Ryan Castile.
Castile putting a great affiliated career up. He was obviously the MVP last year for the Aces. Someone who is dearly missed by the fans and by the staff here at the Aces, but we wish him best of luck across the sea.
Played in the Arizona Fall League. 0-2 pitch, fastball swung on and missed strike 3. Throwback down to first to try to catch the runner off guard. Numata's throw just late. So another strikeout. Number 7 for Godbold. Remember, this is a team in Sydney that struck out 14 times on Friday night and fanned 12 times against Cody Buchel, which is a Melbourne Aces high for a starting pitcher.
And Godbold has been efficient all game. He got in early trouble, maybe throwing too many strikes in the first inning. He's shaking it up a little bit. You can to confuse this lineup. He gets better as he goes along.
Glenn on first, two away here in the top half of the fifth. Brings up Alex Howell, spelled Ho, silent E. Righty versus lefty, first pitch. Breaking ball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike count, 0-1. Sydney, three runs on six hits and no errors. Aces, two runs on two hits and three errors. So a colorful stat line. Godbold from the third base side of the rubber. From the stretch, 0-1 pitch, breaking ball swung on, line down the right field line, but foul. Bounces out of play, count 0-2.
How with a similar wide stance, maybe you want to call it like Skip Schumacher, a guy who doesn't quite settle into his swing until the ball's almost already there, generates quite a bit of pop to the pull field.
Skip Schumacher, that is quite the name drop. Appreciate it up in this side of the booth. That's pretty impressive. No balls, two strikes, two outs. Godbold from the stretch fires a waist fastball that's taken outside. Howe keeps the bat on the shoulders. Count 0-2. Who's your favorite Brewers player of all time?
Of all time is tough. You got to go with the kid, Robin Yount. He's no longer a kid anymore. I didn't get to see him play a whole lot. And I got a pretty good story after this pitch of the 1-2 from Godbold coming.
Chest high set, looking back at first. The 1-2 offering. Fastball that's 2-2.
So it must have been 1991. Robin Yount was at 2,999 hits. I was but a toddler, maybe 1 year old at the time. Don't quite remember it, obviously. But my parents assure me I was in attendance for Robin Yount's 3,000-hit game at the now-defunct County Stadium in Milwaukee.
Wow. Site of the Major League movies. Major League One.
I know a few people who snuck into that movie.
2-2 pitch. Fastball that swung on and blooped into shallow right field for a base hit. Wormfields, it quickly comes up throwing, and he holds Glenn at second. So Howe with the bloop single. Glenn from first to second. Two runners on, two outs. And in steps third baseman Zach Shepard.
Good time for Godbold to take a breath, step off the hill, really think about it. Numata even going out, giving direction to the defense, giving a few signs. Every run is important in a 3-2 game, especially middle innings like this. You don't want to let it get out of hand too early. You want to stay within reach and make your runs when they count for the offense.
Be careful with Shepard. Two-run blast yesterday. Former Australian Junior National Player of the Year in 2011. It's when he signed with the Detroit Tigers organization. Righty versus righty, first pitch. Fastball that's grounded sharply. Backhanded by Cruz at short. Throws to second, and it's not in time to get Howe. A bit surprising to see Cruz, knowing that his only play was at second, threw completely across his body. And that's a bang-bang play, almost got Howe.
It looked like he was there safe just in time. Good job by Harmon on the bunt. On the bounce, excuse me, grabbing that ball and not letting it filter back to first.
It'll be interesting to see what the ruling is there. Technically, that's a fielder's choice, but the case could be made that everybody was going to be safe regardless. Can't tell what it is as of now. Bases loaded, though, for the Blue Sox, and I'll bring up Trent DeAntonio, first pitch. Breaking ball that's taken up high. Count 1-0. It's ruled as, and that's the right call. Would have taken a miraculous effort by Cruz to get any base runner in that situation.
I give him credit just getting to the ball there, Al.
Saving a run, possibly. One ball, no strikes. Pitch from Godbold. Fastball that's taken up high. Count 2-0. This is where you have to locate with the bases loaded. You walk DeAntonio, who's already drawn two walks today. You're looking at a 4-2 ball game.
Before, this is a Sox lineup that has been patient today and in the series. They do strike out quite a bit, but they are not.
2-0 pitch, fastball that's bounced down the first base side. Foul count, 2-1. They don't take their at-bats cheaply.
They do not. They are taking them 5-6. We've seen as many as 8 and 9 pitch at-bats. They're making Melbourne's pitchers work. And when your bullpen's pretty thin like it is today for the Aces, that's not something not something you're too fond of.
Two balls, one strike, two outs, top of the fifth. Bases loaded full of Blue Sox. Already holding a 3-2 advantage. 2-1 pitch, fastball swung up, bounce. Diving stop made by the first baseman. Deglan, who underhands it over to Godbolt. And it beats it to the bag in time to get D'Antonio. Fine play made by Kellin Deglan. Likely a run, possibly two. Hayden Godbolt, his fourth consecutive scoreless inning. No runs on three hits, no errors, but three men left on base. Aces trailing by a score of 3-2 here in the middle of the fifth. Bottom half of the fifth inning. Aces defense holds. 3-2 ball game. It will be Cruz and Engel as well as Numata to begin the bottom half of the fifth. Aces trail 3-2. Cruz takes a breaking ball for a strike for the first pitch. Count 0-1. As the Wells 0-1 pitch is lined into right field for a base hit. Who came into this series without an ABL hit in his career, now has hit safely in his last three games, a leadoff single. And that'll bring up Adam Engel and turn over the lineup card for the Aces.
Cruz recently traded from the Braves affiliate to the Houston Astros affiliate over in the States. He isn't a prolific base stealer, but he is a guy they're going to keep an eye on.
First pitch to Engel, who squares around to bunt. Kind of pulled the bat back towards his face, but still got a piece of it and bounced it down the first base side. Foul count 0-1. Engel with a bunt single in the third. Reached base twice, walked in the first, and stole a bag. ABL leading 8 stolen bases this season, which is even more impressive with the guy sporting a 160 batting average. 0-1 offering. Engel squares around to bunt. Pulls back at a fastball that hits the outside corner for a strike. Engel shocked, as well as the Aces dugout. They should have had a cam on that one.
There's been some frustration on both sides of the lineups in terms of the strike zone today. I think our home plate umpire, Richard Mason, has been pretty consistent. Whether or not it is agreeable on both sides, he has called balls and strikes throughout the series this way.
Changeup that's taken on the outside corner for a called third strike. Engel in disbelief. And both pitches look not only well outside of the zone, but also high.
Something I've noticed coming across from the States, the outside pitch here in Australia is given more than perhaps these American hitters are accustomed to, and you've been noticing an adjustment over the past three series.
I'll call it the outer double black. Wide zone, one out here in the fifth. For Lachlan Wells with a runner on first, in steps Chase Numata. Lefty versus righty, first pitch fastball that's taken well up high. Count 1-0. Mitch a Twitter shout out, but he'd rather go incognito on there.
Sometimes you gotta keep it simple. Stay off the internet as much as possible, kids.
Stay in school.
Stay in school. Start reading books.
Twitter is bad.
You don't need Twitter and Facebook to have fun.
But we do up here anyway.
But we do up here anyway.
One ball, no strikes, pitch from Wells. Changeup that's taken right down the middle for a strike, but it also looked high from here. Count 1-1. Aces with three hits. One here to lead off the fifth. It's Jared Cruz who stands on first. Cruz was slated to play second base today, but right before game time moved to short as he and Brad Harmon switched spots.
It's a decision that may have saved a run, too.
1-1 pitch, fastball swung on, popped up. Shallow right field going up. Back is Lysard, and backing up, he makes the catch on the front edge of the outfield grass. Two away. Back to first, and I'll bring up Harmon.
That's one in baseball terminology they call a can of corn, but maybe not too easy as the wind is blowing, pushing the second baseman at least 5 to 6 meters to his left. Did make the play successfully, though. We've got two outs in the bottom of the fifth inning.
Ah, meters reference going with the metric system.
Got to stick with it. Got to learn it the best I can.
Lefty versus righty. First pitch to Harmon. It's taken low. Count 1-0. It's still a work in progress for me. I'm getting there, fans. I'm trying.
Miles per hour to kilometers per hour is still a little difficult. I don't think I'm understanding that.
But they
that
still
one.
Go by miles per hour here when it comes to baseball speeds and pitches. 1-0 pitch. Breaking ball that's taken in the dirt. Count. If you look at the on the right and left field line, that is in feet. 300 feet down the left field line. So,
an interesting combination of the metric system and the goofy American system that we can all agree is a little bizarre.
Cultural clash. 2-0 offering. Fastball that's taken up high. Count 3-0. So the Aces were down 3-0 after a three-run first by the Blue Sox, but they come back, two runs in the third, RBI ground up by Deglan, RBI bases loaded, walk drawn by Harmon, who's at the plate with a 3-0 count, Cruz on first, pitch, fastball that's taken on the inside corner for a strike, count 3-1. Harmon's been awfully impressive so far, and one of the lone bright spots for this Aces team. Could really use a victory. 3-1 offering. Fastball swung on, popped up. Right side of the infield. Tough play. Lysart racing towards the line. And in foul territory, he makes the catch for the final out here in the fifth. Not sure if Mitch stays or Mitch goes. If he does, we appreciate you coming aboard for the broadcast. Your first debut and this side of the press box. You did a great job, Mitch.
Thank you very much, Al. Whether or not I'm sticking around for the bottom half or not, thank you for everybody listening, and go Aces.
Aces trailing by a score of 3-2 when we come back the sixth inning here at Melbourne Ballpark.
appreciate it, Mitchell.
Thanks for having me.
No problem. Top half of the sixth inning, we go. Aces trailing by a score of 3-2, and we have a pitching change. Couple, what an outing. He won't get a quality start because he only threw five innings, but he gave up three runs all in the first. Came back with four scoreless frames, gave up eight hits, struck out seven. Unfortunately, is in line for the loss. He will make way for Kazuki Miyata, who's been one of the main bright spots bullpen. You get to his stats in a moment. You will see Michael Lysart, lefty versus righty, first pitch fastball that's taken up high. Count 1-0. Miyata 1-0 with a 4.05 ERA, making his eighth appearance so far this season. That ties him for the ABL. Miyata, 13 1/3 innings pitch, 17 strikeouts. 1-0 pitch, breaking ball, and a beauty taken on the inside corner to the right-hand hitting Lysart. Count 1-1. Welcome back to the booth, Fritta. We appreciate having Mitch Keller in the booth for the last two innings.
Yeah, Mitch did a fine job.
One ball, one strike. Miyata from the stretch fires a fastball that's taken low. Count 2-1. Kazuki Miyata, 82 centimeters, 79 kilograms. Just turned 26 years old. Exact same age as me. Just 2 months younger. Born on November 16th. 2-1 pitch. Fastball that's taken up. Count 2-1. In case you all were wondering, my birthday's on September 15th. So 2 months and a day older than Kazuki Miyata. Fred, I won't even ask how much older you are than Kazuki Miyata.
What's my Twitter handle?
At Fritta, F-R-I-T-A, 51.
That's so I'll remember. All right. I remember when I went on Twitter.
3-1 pitch. Fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike. Count 3-2.
I did mention
so
I couldn't.
So crafty.
I did mention I couldn't remember what I did yesterday. That's my key to remember how old I was when I actually joined up Twitter.
Context clues.
There's a lot of them in my life, mate.
Full count, nobody out. Lefty versus righty. Fastball that hits the inside corner for a called third strike. Lysart in disbelief. Liberal strike zone from Richard Mason, the home plate umpire. Might have been a bit low.
Could have been a bit low, but it caught the inside part of the plate. That would be the question, was the height of the pitch. There's been a lot of questions over this weekend, some unnecessary to the umpires. Richard Mason umpiring the plate today. Lysart sits down with a strikeout.
One away. Kazuki Miyata face off against Tyler Bortnick, who swings at the first pitch and drives it down the right field line, fouling out of play. Count 0-1. Bortnick standing in from the right side. Miyata, a southpaw, meaning he's a lefty. Now 18 strikeouts in 13 2/3 innings. He's second on the team in strikeouts, and he's a reliever. He's one behind Cody Buchel.
Yeah, he's been terrific. You mentioned the eight appearances he's had with the team. Really has good stuff. Flat fastball sometimes, depending, but good breaking ball.
0-1 pitch. Fastball that's taken inside. It almost hits Bortnick in the midsection. Count 1-1. Miyata, one of the Cebu Lions players who has come over to the Aces. Not likely to stay the innings. He will be on an innings limit, which might actually be coming up soon. 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball just taken low. Bortnick thinks about taking a hack, but keeps the bat on the shoulders. Count 2-1.
Japanese players from the Cebu Lions here. They tend to go back before Christmas. It's a ongoing players agreement in Japanese baseball that their professional athletes get January off in preparation for their upcoming spring training and or season.
2-1 pitch. Fastball swung on and chopped foul behind home plate. Count 2-2. The Aces will actually get another dose of Cebu Lions players. They're coming in, if not this week, still a tentative date. Couple pitchers.
Yeah, it's been an ongoing fluid arrangement with Cebu. Very happy both the arrangement. but they try to have players head home for Christmas.
Two balls, two strikes. Pitch from Miyata is a breaking ball that's taken inside. Looked like it might have hit Bortnick from this angle, but he's not heading down to first. So the count moves to three balls and two strikes. Aces trailing 3-2. Top half of the sixth inning. The finale of a four-game set between the two teams. I guess you can call it a rubber match because if the Aces win, they eat the series. If they lose, they lose the series 3-1.
Yeah, really important they win this game, though. Just for the stability of the team.
3-2 pitch. Breaking ball. Swung on and missed strike three. A pretty looping curveball. Bortnick well out in front. He was fooled. And back-to-back strikeouts here for Kazuki Miyata in the sixth.
There's that breaking ball I just mentioned. Really is a nice pitch. Throws backdoor breaking ball at times. Just tries to nick the outside edge. But that one low and in. And a half-hearted swing there from Tyler Bortnick. Beaten all the way on that great breaking ball by Miyata.
Two outs, top of the sixth. Sydney batters have struck out 9 times so far today. Brings up Trennell. Versus lefty from the stretch. Miyata the pitch, breaking ball that swung on and missed. Count 0-1. That breaking ball, so difficult against left-handed hitters because make that start completely outside the strike zone and stops on the outer portion of the plate.
Yeah, it really breaks a lot. It's a hard snapping break too. So out of the hand, it looks like it might be a ball up and in. But then, as you mentioned there, Alex, it ends up low and away. Hard to hit.
0-1 pitch. Fastball swung on and missed strike two. And when you can throw a curveball, your fastball doesn't seem nearly as flat, and he blows one by Olchin.
Yeah, you can spot that. You know, the fastball doesn't have to be overpowering. You just pop it in and out, jam it on the hands. When you like that, makes the fastball all the more deceptive and harder to hit.
No balls, two strikes, two outs. Sayuchi pitch, breaking ball, swung on, driven a deep left field. Back is Hendricks, gets turned around, that ball lands over his head and bounces towards the wall. Hendricks gets it quickly, throws it into second, but the throw not in time to get slides in safely with a two-out double. Gives the Blue Sox a runner in scoring position. They'll bring up Josh Dean.
Hard hit ball off the bat of Olchin. There's a major league quality of a hitter, though. A lot of these guys, we're just talking about the prowess of Miyata and the good breaking ball he's got. Good hitters learn to hang in there, drive the ball the other way. You saw there from Trent Olchin, hit that ball hard. Hendricks was a little slow on the uptake on getting to the ball, ended up cruising over his head to the base of the wall for a stand-up double.
Two-out base runner for the Blue Sox. In steps a dangerous hitter in Josh Dean, who's already 2-for-3 today, knocked in two of those runs in the first. Two-run single. Lefty versus lefty. First pitch is another breaking ball that's taken on the inside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. Now 9 hits for the Blue Sox. 9 hits and 9 strikeouts. It's feast or famine for this Blue Sox offense. Looking back at second is Miyata from the stretch. Still looking. Now fires towards the plate. A fastball that's taken low and a fine stop made by Miyata. Fans, if you are still listening in, unfortunately you can't tweet me right now because I don't have a computer and my phone's dead and this left his charger downstairs. So I'm going to leave it to Tweeting Fritta. Get those followers up at Fritta, F-R-I-T-A, 1-T, not 2, 51. So F-R-I-T-A, 51. Tweet him, follow him, let us know you're listening in.
Absolutely.
1-1 pitch, breaking ball that's taken low. Count 2-1. Two outs, top of the sixth inning. Aces trailing by a score of 3-2. That score has been that way since the bottom half of the third. Some fine pitching for both teams. It's been even more impressive for the Aces with a short bullpen today. Hayden Gobbold went 5 frames, gave up 3 runs, is in line for the loss. Kazuki Miyata, and before the 2-1 pitch, he'll look back at second. Olchin jumps in safely. Nobody was holding him on. Count Count 2-1. Two outs. Aces trail by one. Top of the sixth, runner on second. The 2-1 offering. Fastball that just misses inside, backs up Dean a little bit. Count 3-1. Aces just three hits. Sydney with nine. They're still in this ballgame. Most importantly, Miyata from the stretch, 3-1 pitch. Fastball that misses outside. Ball four to the left hand hitting Dean, and he draws a five-pitch walk. So after striking out the first two batters he faces, a double to Olchin, walk to Dean, brings runners at first and second. And here comes Alex Glenn. Glenn reached base twice. Reached on an error in the third. Singled in the fifth.
Hit that monster home run last night, Alex Glenn, over the scoreboard. Tied the game up in the ninth. 8 apiece. So he has great power. Runners at first and second for the Blue Sox.
Miyata working from the third base side of the rubber. First pitch, lefty versus lefties. A breaking ball that's taken just inside. Count 1-0. Glenn, a pull hitter by trade, and that's how the defense is sort of adjusting to Glenn. Right fielder, Wern, playing Glenn right down the line. Engel, the center fielder, shaded in right center, about 5 feet from his normal position, and Hendricks playing in the left center field gap. Lefty versus lefty. Pitch, fastball that's taken outside. Count 2-0, and Kazuki Miyata losing goal here on the latter part of the sixth inning. You hope not tired. Guy's really thrown a lot as he flexes that left elbow.
Yeah, flexing. I was just looking at the same thing, flexing that arm. It's sometimes a real indicator from a pitcher if he's actually flexing his arm. Maybe a little tired in the arm.
2-0 pitch, fastball swung on and missed strike one. Well, he didn't look tired there. But if you look at Miata's motion, there's just so much torque there. And I mean that in the sense that that arm goes back and forth. Not much from his legs in terms of movement. It's a simple slingshot motion.
Yeah, I mean this in the utmost respect. It's an Asian sort of feel towards the pitching. They pause a lot. American ways to be really fluid with the motion. Asian ways to pause quite a bit through the motion and a lot of arm.
2-1 pitch. Fastball swung on. Blooped shallow left field. That ball will fall in for a base hit. Rounding third is Olchin. He will score. The throw in by Hendricks is caught up by Davies, the third baseman. That is Dean, who stays on second, and Alex Glenn with a two-out RBI single here in the sixth. Lead back up to two. Melbourne trails by a score of 4-2.
That wasn't a bad pitch from Miyata, outside corner of the plate, low and away. Alex Glenn just did a tremendous job of staying on the ball. About being a pull hitter, and the Aces were shading him for the pull hit. It shows the quality of the hitting to actually just stay on the ball, hit it the other way, and Glenn drives it into left field for an RBI single.
Runners on first and second, still just two outs. Brings up the righty, Will Swanner. Lefty versus righty. First pitch is a fastball. Top foul down the third base side. Count 0-1. And that's where the shift in the defensive alignment really impacts the game. Hendricks was just 5 feet, maybe 6 feet shy of reaching that ball.
Yeah, being the left-hander, the ball always curls towards the line. If you hit it towards right field, it'll curl towards the right field line. You hit it to left field, curl towards the left field line.
Miyata from the stretch, 0-1 pitch. Another breaking ball. This one swung on and fouled back behind home plate. Count 0-2. Now double-digit hits for Sydney. First two games of the series, 6 combined hits. Now the second two games, 24 combined hits.
Yeah, it's an amazing turnaround. That game one that you talked about, they won that game 5-2 on two hits. And then 24 in these last two games. It's an incredible turnaround, but this is what this team's capable of, the Blue Sox. They can really turn on a lot of power in their lineup. Speed, good mix. The games they've shown that power.
Aces now trail 4-2. No balls, two strikes, two outs. Pitch, fastball that's taken up high to the righty Swanner. Count one and two. Aces were down by three after the first inning. Brought it back to a 3-2 ball game. And just a moment ago, Alex Glenn, two-out RBI single for the Blue Sox. He stands on first. Joshua Dean on second. 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball that's taken just outside. Back to a breaking ball that didn't break enough.
Just during the break when you had Mitch Keller up here doing some calling, I was able to get down in amongst the crowd and have a look around. There really is a nice crowd, both down the first and third base lines. People with their dogs barking the park day here at Melbourne Ballpark. And a good little crowd in the stands. You can hear them clapping now, trying to help Miyata along.
All twos across the scoreboard. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Pitch from Miyata. Breaking ball swung on, tap foul off the glove of the catcher. Numata could not hold on to the ball. Miyata to Numata. Battery right now for the Aces. Count remains 2-2.
No action down in the pen for the Aces. There is some happening down there in the for the Blue Sox. We'll get a look at who that is in a minute.
2-2 count. Dean on second, Glenn on first. Top of the sixth. Aces trail 4-2. 2-2 offering from Miyata. Breaking ball swung on. Foul back at the screen behind home plate. Long at bat here. A battle between Swanner and Miyata. Count 2-2, and this has to be Miyata's only inning.
Yeah, you would think so. You mentioned he's had 8 appearances. He's done quite a bit of work. That's why I was looking down in the pen to see what may be happening down there, but nothing at this stage. But this is a nice at-bat here from Will Swanner. Really hanging in there.
Miyata sets at the chest. Glove bound by his belly button. 2-2 pitch. Fastball swung on, blooped shallow right field, coming. Dives head first and he makes the catch. Word takes a tumble, but a fine grab and it ends the potential threat for the Blue Sox. They do score a run. They do so on two hits. Leave two men left on base. That's a big stop there for the Aces. And in the middle of the sixth, they trail by a score of 4-2 here at Melbourne Ballpark. Lachlan Wells in for a sixth inning of work. Aces trailing by two. Middle of the Aces due up. Deglan, Davies, and Wern. Deglan squares around to bunt at the first pitch, and he lays it down, foul out of play. Down the third base side, count 0-1, and I do like Deglan's thinking, because look at the shift that's being played right now, Fritta. The second baseman, Uli, starts playing in shallow right field. Shortstop Bortnick's playing behind the second base bag, and the third baseman, Shepard, is playing normally where the shortstop is, so there's a lot of room down the third base side. Lefty versus lefty. 0-1 pitch, breaking ball that's taken low. Count 1-1. Now, you could play devil's advocate on it, Fritta, and a guy with as much power as Deglan, 4 home runs, 13 RBI so far. Do you want him trying to lay down a bunt when you're down by 2 runs? Possibly not. 1-1 that's taken low. Count 2-1.
Yeah, I think it's a real heads-up, mature thing from Deglan to try and do. They're down by 2 runs here. They need to get runners on base.
2-1 offering fastball that dots the outer black for a strike, and Deglan looking back in the direction of home plate umpire Richard Mason, putting his hand over. Another mature move.
Yeah, he didn't like that call. Just a look.
2-1 offering. Breaking ball that's taken up high. It's actually a 2-2 offering. Brings the count to 3-2. Bottom of the sixth. Final game of a 4-game set between the Aces and the Blue Sox. Aces trailing by a score of 4-2. Payoff pitch. Overhand breaking ball that's taken up high. Ball 4. Almost hits Deglan, but he reaches base for the first time today. One out in the sixth.
From Deglan. Get on base. Brings Josh Davies to bat. Aces need to get back in this game. Middle of sixth now. Going to the bottom. Runner on, none out.
Davies struck out twice today. Takes a first pitch fastball low. Count 1-0. Davies a 3 last night, 2 double and a single. Came into the game hitting 308, 2 home runs, 8 RBIs. Lefty versus righty. Pitch. Fastball that's taken on the inside corner for a strike. Count 1-1. And now Davies barking in the direction of home plate umpire Richard Mason. He may need some hearing aids because he's getting quite arousing from both dugouts right now.
Yeah, it seems to have been that way all weekend. As you mentioned, this is game 4 of a 4-game set. So the first 3 games has been similar, where players are just questioning the strike zone at them.
1-1 pitch, fastball that's taken low. Count 2-1, Lachlan Wells, 17-year-old left-handed pitcher, making his first appearance with the Blue Sox this weekend. Pitched 3 games last year, 2-1 pitch. Fastball that's taken inside, almost hits Davies, who sends a long glare in the direction of Wells, and you can sense the tension kind of picking up between the two teams right now.
Yeah, only 17 years of age. I did say earlier they need to be patient. The kid has to start fatiguing, getting tired.
3-1 offering fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike against the righty Davies, and that fastball surely popped the glove.
Yeah, it did pop in the glove. He's still got something there. That's I'm talking about being patient at bat. Try and take 8 pitches at a time.
3-2 pitch, fastball that's taken inside, ball 4, and he walks him. So 2 consecutive walks to begin the 6th inning. Aces have something going, nobody out. Bring up Scotty Worm.
And right there, that's the key. You know, in Lachlan Wells' mind, young kid, only 17, he's just thrown says, Pop's Jill coming out, manager of the Blue Sox, to have a chat. There is action down in the pen, so I would think he's going to go. He's going to the pen now. We're going to see a relief pitcher. Young kid has done a terrific job for the Sydney Blue Sox here. Back-to-back walks has put the nail in the coffin for him today. Terrific young outing for the young fella, only 17. What's that, 6 1/3? Oh, no, five and a third.
So with the quick break, we'll go to some of our reads. Our sponsors, the Melbourne Aces, are brought to you by Jet Courier, Australia's premier courier providing point-to-point courier services you can count on. Jet Couriers are ready and available to pick up and deliver 365 days a year, 24 hours a day. When you want efficient professional service, you can confidently depend on Jet Couriers. Also, today's game is brought to you by Franklin Sports, the leading name in baseball gloves since 1946. Remember also the Australian Baseball League All-Star Game will be here at Melbourne Ballpark Wednesday, December 16th.
17th. That'd be the third time Melbourne Ballpark will have hosted the All-Star Game. The last two have been really well supported, thanks to Victorian government, who supports the All-Star Game here at Melbourne Ballpark. Really have been a treat for people. You can catch the game also on ESPN. They'll be hosting the broadcast of the game. But you get to see the best Australia has to offer. They've put together a great squad. Australia doesn't get the opportunity to play as a team, as a national team, too often. We have to travel a lot to international tournaments. Things like the World Baseball Classic have popped up recently. That's only every 4 years, though. The Premier 12 is another tournament. It was just renamed World Cup, where the top 12 nations will get to play in it. It's millions of dollars on the line in that tournament.
New pitcher for the Blue Sox. That's Vaughn Harris. Out of the ball game comes Lachlan Wells, and for all intents and purposes, he pitched pretty well. 5 1/3 innings pitch. He's given up 2 runs on 3 hits so far. Again, he won't give up more hits, but the two runners on base right now are his responsibility. Deglan and Davies, they each walked. Harris this season, 0-1, 16.20 ERA. Righty versus lefty to earn. He squares around to bunt, lays it down the third base side, but it'll go foul. Count 0-1. Harris pitched in game 2 of this series. Pitched an inning scoreless. Fans, again, if you're listening in, you can't tweet me right now, or you can, I just won't get it. But also, let Fritta know. At Fritta, F-R-I-T-A, 5-1. Now I know what 5-1 stands for.
Keep it our secret, okay? And tell too many people. Vaughn Harris, a real stalwart of the Sydney Blue Sox, Sydney baseball in general. It's time called at the plate by Wern. Harris was just taking a bit of time, so it's a real cat and mouse game happening right now amongst the pitcher and the hitter. They play a little mind game, a game within a game, as I call it.
The 0-1 pitch, Wern squaring around to bunt, lays it down in front of home. Picking it up as the catcher, Swanner, one play to first, and he throws it wide. It draws Dean off the bag, makes the catch, but everybody's safe.
Will Swanner actually played that one badly then. That bunt was easy enough to just get an out. What he did do, as soon as he bounced out, the ball popped up easily for him to grab, and he looked at third base. He was never going to have a play at third base. He should have realized when going for the ball, he was never going to have a play at third base. He goes straight to first. The problem was he attempted and then realized halfway through it wasn't going to happen. Tried to go to first base, too late, good speed by Wern. Sees him beat it out, base is loaded.
Base is loaded, full of aces, brings up Justin Huber, righty versus righty, first pitch, fastball, swung on and missed strike one, so that'll be a sacrifice E2. So Wern gets credit for the sack bunt, but the wild throw gives the aces the bases loaded. Deglan at third, Davies on second, Wern at first. Nobody out. Pitch to Huber. Breaking ball swung on and missed strike two. Harris struck out Huber in game 2 of this series. Two guys who know each other pretty well through the Australia baseball circuit. Both of them around the same age.
Aces need Huber right here. Bases loaded. None out here in this innings. Trailing by 2.
Harris from the stretch. Pitch. Breaking ball taken in the dirt. Count 1-2. This inning all started when Lachlan Wells walked Kellin Deglan and Josh Davies to begin the frame, then taken out of the game for Harris. First batter he faced was Wern on a sack bunt attempt. Will Swanner misplayed the bunt and threw it wide down the first. Drew the first baseman, Dean. 1-2 pitch. Fastball swung up, bounced down the third base side, and it's fair. Rolls to the corner. One run will score. Davies will score. Stopping at third is Wern. And trotting in a second with a two-out, make that a two-run Nobody out, double. Justin Huber. Clutch. Aces all tied up at four apiece now with the Blue Sox.
Popishill's really animated with his discussion here. Aces played umpire. That ball hit the line before third base, but they're arguing that it actually... And he's been tossed out of the game. Popishill's been tossed for making a gesture, showing the umpire up. Mason didn't like it. Pecking at him now. He's been tossed out of this game as he makes his way into the dugout. He did not like that call. Will Swanner, the catcher, didn't like the call. They were very animated right from the start. Vaughan Harris was animated also. They're saying the ball did not go over the base. It hit on the line. There was a puff of chalk, and they're saying it curled foul before it got to the bag, as Tommy Thompson's just coming out to have a chat with home plate umpire Mason. Is telling him everything's okay, not to worry about it.
Two-run double from Justin Huber. That is huge. We have a pinch runner, I believe. Brings up Josh Hendricks. Aces tack on two here. Still nobody out. We have a tie game. Runners at second and third. For Josh Hendricks, infield playing in. It's Ben Leslie, the pinch runner. Hendricks swings, sends a drive. Down the left field line. That's a base hit. Warren scores. The pinch runner, Leslie, rounding third. He scores, and sliding into second with a two-run double is Josh Hendricks. Back-to-back two-run doubles. A four-run sixth inning here for the Aces. They take their first lead of the ballgame, 6-4.
Doesn't that get the crowd on its feet? There's an outstanding hitting there. Josh Hendricks taking the first pitch he saw, pulled it straight down the line. Zach Shepard dived, tried to make an attempt on it. Ball bounced over his glove, goes down as a clean base hit. Two-run double there to Josh Hendricks. Aces take the lead, 6-4.
Still nobody out. Brings up Jared Cruz. Josh Hendricks with the second hit of the ballgame. He's on second. Cruz squares around to bunt, lays it down in front of the pitcher. That is Harris, who looks towards the runner at third, throws over to first. The ball bobbled by Dean, then picked up, and it just beats Cruz to the bag. So give Jared a sacrifice bunt.
It's Tommy Thompson now out questioning the umpire's call. Stewie Howe, the umpire down the line there, telling Tommy Thompson, the ball was dropped and bobbled at the feet of Dean, but he picked it up in time before Jared Cruz could get up there. Thompson's not going to win this discussion.
Really been an eventful game, Fredo.
Absolutely. Aces back in the lead here, 6-4. Frustrations coming from the Sydney Blue Sox. Manager Popshield being tossed out of this game.
Aces with four runs, back-to-back two-run doubles from Justin Huber and Josh Hendricks. Wow.
Blue Sox players now fielding up. Want to cut this run at the plate. Just the one out here.
Righty versus righty. First pitch to Engel is a breaking ball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike.
Hard hit ball straight at them. They'll come to the plate. If Josh Hendricks goes, they still have first base open. Let's play. They just need to cut this run at the plate, keep them in the game.
The 0-1 pitch, fastball swung on, bounce right to the second base. Playing on the grass, looks back, the runner at third, fires over to first. And retires Engel. Two away here in the sixth. Bring up catcher Chase Numata.
One hop up, hard hit ball from Engel, straight at Lysort. Check the runner at third, Hendricks. Just an easy underhand throw there to Dean to retire. Two out now. Bottom of the six innings. Aces have put four on the board in this innings. Couple of bunts, couple of hits, couple of doubles.
Infield back. Normal depth with a runner on third and two outs. First pitch to the lefty, Numata. A fastball that's taken on the inside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. Justin Huber, welcome back. His third double of the series. His two-run double ties it up. Then one batter later, Josh Hendricks with a two-run double as Numata swings through an 0-1 changeup.
That's the way to put runs on the board in a hurry. It's back-to-back hits. Managers love back-to-back hits. It's been an area that Aces have lacked this year. We saw it there, though, and that's what can happen. Four on the board in no time.
0-2 pitch. Breaking ball swung on a line between the hole at third. It's short in the left field for a base hit. Hendricks scores from third, and the hits just keep on coming for the Aces. RBI single from Chase Numata. His fourth RBI on the year, fifth run on the inning for the Aces, and they're up 7-4.
Yeah, nice hitting by Chase Numata. That ball's low and away. He went down and just poked it into that gap between third and short. Wasn't that hard hit a ball, just a spot for himself. Nick tried to get it. Zach Shepard tried to get it. Rolled through between both of them into left field for a clean base hit.
That ball had eyes as Harmon steps up and takes a first pitch fastball in the inside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. As Tony Gwynn liked to say, ball was hitting the 5.5 hole.
Yeah, absolutely. It was right on 5.5.
A one offering. Check swing at a breaking ball, and Harmon bounced it down the first base side. Foul. What an inning for the Aces. Down for the entire ball game. Down 3-0, then 3-2, then 4-2. Five runs here in the sixth.
Yeah, they needed this innings. They really need to get a win here, just for their own confidence.
0-2 pass taken outside.
Last night was a real confidence killer, holding the lead going into the ninth. Ended up losing in 11. But to come back here, Blue Sox scored three in the first innings on a couple of errors, a couple of clean base hits to the Blue Sox.
1-2. Swung on and lined up the middle. Diving stop made by Lysart, the second baseman. Throw down to first is not in time. A for effort for Lysart, sliding feet first behind the bag at second. Fields it, long throw over to first, but Harmon legs out the infield single. Brings runners at first and second here with two outs in the sixth, and the Aces have backed up Kellin Deglan.
Yeah, hard hit ball back up the middle, as you mentioned there. Michael Lysart did a terrific job to get across to it, picked it on the backhand, slid, little pop-up slide. Just not enough on the throw to get the speed to beat it out just right by half a step.
Righty versus lefty pitch to Deglan. Fastball swung on, chopped down the first base side, who takes it over to the bag himself for the final out here in the sixth. Round of applause for the Aces offense. They send 10 batters to the plate. They score five runs. They do so on four hits, one error, and they leave two men left on base. After six, Aces with their first lead. They're up by a score 7-4 here at Melbourne Ballpark. Aces with their first lead of the ball game. They're up by a score of 7-4. Five runs in the sixth. Highlighted RBI single, two RBI doubles, two two-run doubles at that. Kazuki Miyata in for his second inning of work. We'll see Hal Shepard and D'Antonio. First pitch, lefty versus lefty, is a fastball that's taken up high count, 1-0. The RBI single was by Chase Numata. The two-run doubles are by Hendricks and Justin Hubert, respectively. 1-0 pitch. Fastball that dots the outside corner for a strike count, 1-0. And it seems to me that just the presence of Huber in that lineup for the Aces has kind of, you know, brought it to a point where they're really starting to feel comfortable at the plate.
Yeah, everybody's, you know, shoulders are back, chest is out when Justin's in the team. Alex Howe not happy with that call there. The Blue Sox seem to be spending a bit of time complaining at the moment rather than getting on with the business, whether they're rough calls or not.
1-1 offering, breaking ball taken just low, count 2-1, while their manager already kicked out of the game.
Yep.
He's thrown out, tossed. Arguing Justin Huber's double, saying that it was a foul ball. Hit down the third base side. 2-1 pitch. Fastball swung on, popped up, drifting into foul territory down the third base side, and Davies ranging towards the sidewall runs out of room. This ball lands foul and out of play. Count 2-2.
Yeah, it's a real opportunity for the Aces to cement this lead right now. If they get in and out with a quick three-out inning, not worry so much about what the Blue Sox are doing, if they're going to be worried about balls and strikes and what they think are rough calls down the lines and things like that, let them go about their business. Aces need to get three quick outs and get back in and swing the bats again.
Two balls, two strikes, nobody out. Pitch from Miyata, breaking ball, swung on and missed, strike three. Third strikeout of the ball game for Kazuki Miyata. At a strikeout number 11 on the ball game for the Blue Sox hitters.
Alex Howe just did add a brief word with the umpire as he walked off. Their mind is not on the job right now. Aces need to take advantage of that. Well, they're slightly off and worrying about calls and is it a strike or not a strike.
Lefty versus righty. Pitch to Shepard, breaking ball that's taken right down the middle for a strike. Count 0-1, and Richard Mason's having so many 10-second conversations with people, he should be speed dating right now.
Yes.
Unbelievable. Oh-1 pitch. Fastball swung on and missed, strike two. Kazuki Miyata in for a second inning of work, and looking at the Aces bullpen, nobody going right now.
Nobody down there, so it's Miata's right now. Seventh innings. Aces hold a 7-4 lead on five runs in that last inning.
The 0-2 pitch. Fastball that's taken outside, count 1-2. This could be a situation, as Miyata has been the best arm in the bullpen for this entire season. Granted, it's only been 3 weeks, but put the ball in the arm of your best hurler and see how it goes.
Yeah, get him to go as long as he can. As you said, no action down in the pen, so this is Miata's right now.
1-2 pitch. Breaking ball that's taken in the dirt. Count 2-2, and it makes me cringe watching him throw that breaking ball because there is so much snapping towards the bottom. Long arms from Miyata. Fortunately, his arm is held up to this point. Two balls, two strikes. Miyata from the stretch gets a sign from Numata. 2-2 pitch. It's a fastball swung on, driven a deep center field angle. Nice read on it. Comes back in as the ball sinks. He makes the grab down by his kneecap. Retires Shepard. Two away, and I'll bring up Trent D'Antonio.
Yeah, it looked to be hit better than it actually was in the end. It looked to pop off the bat and was going to be a drive to the base of the wall. Never had a real chance of getting out, but Engel broke back initially and then realized the ball was getting knocked down by the wind, had to come back and make a shoestringer in the end. Ended up made a fine catch, but slightly misjudged, but the wind conditions got to it.
Fred, I'll make a bold statement here. That ball's hit yesterday. It's about 20 feet over the fence.
Absolutely. You're right there.
First pitch to Trent D'Antonio from the lefty Miyata. A fastball taken on the inside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. Aces 5 runs in the 6th. First lead of the ball game, they were down 3-0, then down 3-2, 4-2, have taken the lead 7-4.
Need this final out here, 2 out here. Top 7.
No balls, 1 strike. Miyata from the stretch. Fires a breaking ball that's taken low. Count 1-1 to recap the scoring. Aces got 2 runs in the 3rd. Just loaded, walk drawn by Brad Harmon. RBI ground out by Kellin Deglan. 5 runs in the 6th inning came from 2 2-run doubles, 1 from Josh Hendricks, 1 from Justin Huber, and an RBI single to Numata. 1-1 pitch, breaking ball that's taken high and tight, almost hits D'Antonio. Count 2-1. Sydney scored 3 runs in the 1st, highlighted by a 2-run single by Josh Dean and an RBI single by Alex Glenn in the 6th. 2-1 pitch, fastball swung on, golfed, shallow left field. Coming on in is Hendricks, a couple steps, makes the catch, and retires D'Antonio for the final out here in the 7th. So a 1-2-3 7th inning for Kazuki Miyata. No runs, no hits, no errors on base. And at stretch time here at Melbourne Ballpark, the Aces lead the Blue Sox by a score of 7-4. Bottom half of the 7th inning, and the Aces looking to add some more runs. They scored 5 in the 6th, have taken their first lead of the ballgame up 7-4. Vaughn Harrison, first pitch to Josh Davies, righty versus righty, is swung on by Davies, lined down the right field line and fouling out of play. Count 0-1. We have a couple listeners tuning in, tweeting Fritta, Itchy and Mitchy, Andrew Kenyon, Big Cam, Amy Koff, Tony Ortega, Dick Bossert. Davies swings at a 0-1 offering, bounced it down the third base side, foul. Count 0-2. Fans, if you are listening in, you can't tweet me right now, or you can, you just won't get it. Or I won't get it. Phone is dead. Computer is being used for this stream. 0-2 pitch. Change up, swung on, blooped, shallow left field. Coming on in is Hal. Ball falls in front of him. So Davies for a second consecutive time. Walked and scored in the 6th, single to lead off the 7th here. And I'll bring up right fielder Scott Wern.
Yeah, that ball just dropped in front of Hal in left field. Just Davies, his first base hit of the night. The day, my bad.
Evening.
Getting there, but
beautiful day for baseball. Wern reached on a sack bunt, swings at the first pitch, grounds it over to Dean at first, who looks towards second instead. Underhand first with Harris covering, and it retires Wern, but that works just like a sacrifice, which he had last at bat. Advances Davies to second. Wern retired. I'll bring up Justin Huber.
Yeah, another opportunity here, as Justin Huber was for after he hit that double last time around. Ben Leslie coming in to hit on this occasion. Real opportunity here for Ben to put a run on the board. Davies at second base.
Righty versus lefty. Pitch. Fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike count. 0-1. Leslie up, taking the place for Huber, as Fritta said. Huber, a two-run double. A tied up the game in the sixth. Aces went on to score three more runs in the inning. 0-1 offering, changeup that count. 1-1. Leslie so far this season, 0-4, three games. Reached on an error. It's also caught stealing. Runner on second, that's Davies. One ball, one strike, one out, bottom of the seventh. Pitch, fastball swung on line down the third base side. Foul as it almost hits third base coach Dean Marnell. Cat-like reflexes getting out of the way of that one.
Yeah, had to really show some footwork to get out of the way of that. Tom Dean Marnell over to coach at third base. If they happen to win this game, you might see Marnell there for a couple more games.
1-2 pitch. Fastball swung on, driven deep down the left field line, but it slices foul and out of play. Count 1-2. Fans, if you are listening in, we will continue. Tweet us at Fritta, F-R-I-T-A, 51. No tweets at Voice of Cohen right now. If you do, I'll allow it. I won't mind it. Just get to it later. 1-2 pitch. Change up, swung on and missed strike three. Leslie Fold strikes out swinging. Two outs here in the seventh. They'll bring up left fielder Josh Hendricks. Hendricks, second start of the series, singled in the third and scored a two-run double in the sixth. He's been quite a spark plug.
Yeah, really has. He's been terrific since he came into this team. Was in the open tryouts, wasn't partially at the start of the season.
Hendricks swings at the first pitch, lofts it into center field, but right at Glenn, who doesn't move. Makes the catch and retires Hendricks for the final out here in the seventh. Aces strand a leadoff base runner. No runs, one hit, no errors. One man left on base. After seven, Aces leading by a score of 7-4 here at Melbourne Ballpark. Top half of the eighth inning, as the Aces lead by a score of 7-4. We have a quick shout out. We have Christine tuning in. Her husband Mark Smith here at the ballpark. Christine, we hear you loud and clear, and we're glad to have you aboard.
Got another one from Anthony Reskin. I do not agree with you, Anthony. Says go Blue Sox. I do not agree.
And here for Kazuki Miyata in his third inning of work. He will see
Lysol.
Believe it's Fortnick and Olchin. Lefty versus righty. First pitch, fastball that's taken up high. Count 1-0. Final game of this four-game set. Aces would love to come away with a victory in this one, like they would in every game. 1-0 pitch, fastball swung on, bounce over towards short. In between hop, Cruz fields it, low throw over to first, but it's dug out of the dirt by Deglan. Quick first out here in the eighth, and it'll bring up shortstop Tyler Bortnick.
Yeah, routine ground ball there, picked up by Jared Cruz. Just a little weak on the throw, dropping it at the feet of Deglan, ended up handling it well, scooped it half volley. First out here, top of the eighth.
Important win for the Aces if they were to go on and get this victory, because last night they were up by four runs at two different parts of the game. They ended up losing the ball game. So this would kind of rewrite the wrong in a sense. Lefty versus righty, pitch, fastball swung off, fisted over towards third. Gobbled up by Davies on the ground, fires a strike over to first. And quickly, two up, two down here for Kazuki Miyata in the eighth. Just cruising right now.
Absolutely, just firing the ball in there. Blue Sox come up swinging. First pitch they see there from Tyler Bortnick. No action down in the pen for the Aces. So again, this innings is Miyata's. Brings to bat the ever-dangerous Trent Holchen.
Tommy Thompson, a man is letting his actions do the talking here. Nobody warming up in the bullpen. This is Kazuki Miyata's ballgame. Two up, two down in the eighth. Aces leading 7-4. Brings up Trent Holchen, doubled and scored in the sixth. Lefty versus lefty. Pitch from Miyata is a changeup that's taken low. Count 1-0. Hope you all are enjoying Aces baseball here at the beautiful Melbourne ballpark.
Trent Holchen with a couple of doubles today. Hit the ball pretty well.
2-for-4. 1-0 offering. Fastball that just misses outside of the left-hand hitting Holchen. Count 2-0. He doubled and scored in the first, doubled in the sixth.
Trent Olchin's bat tweeted me last night. I apologize for the pronunciation, getting that wrong. His was very upset with me.
What did you mispronounce?
I actually said, watch the pitch first.
2-0 fastball taken right down the middle for a strikeout with 2-1.
In my rush to try and get some information out, I actually, Schill is the manager of the Sydney Blue Sox. Mm-hmm. I call him Philibosian.
Who was playing left field for, gotcha.
Slip of the tongue, I apologize. The bat was upset.
Same first letter.
But as soon as you apologize, the bat was okay.
Gotcha.
Bat got better. And as you can see today.
2-1 pitch. Fastball swung on line sharply at the second baseman, Harmon, who takes it on a sharp hop, bobbles, fires over to first. And we're in plenty of time for the final out here. 1-2-3 inning for Kazuki Miyata. No runs, no hits, no errors, no men left on base. Bottom half of the eighth we go. Ace is looking for some more insurance. Runs are up by 4 ball game. Vaughn Harrison for his third inning of work. Aces looking for some insurance. They're up by a score 7-4 here in the bottom half of the eighth, but it's ever secure, really, at any level, but especially for this Aces bullpen so far to this point. Cruz swings at the first pitch, fouls it back out of play behind home plate. Count 0-1, and Jared Cruz has really done his job well hitting out of the nine hole, walking and scoring in the third. Single in the fifth, sacrifice bunt in the sixth. 0-1 offering, breaking ball swung on, foul back out of play over the party deck down the first base side.
A little shout out to Dave Nowicki, getting a little pose up there with Maverick out in the stands.
Dave, a longtime listener because his son Ryan works with the Aces.
Okay.
The 0-2 offering from Harris. Fastball swung on and fouled back out of play into the Aces dugout. That almost hits on deck hitter Adam Engel. Engel, a former football player, is actually recruited to play Division I football at the University of Wisconsin, ducking in and out of tackles there with the ball coming out of his face. Count remains 0-2, righty versus righty. Pitch to Cruz. Fastball swung on, grounded sharply towards second, right at Lysard, who fields over to first. And retires Cruz. One away here in the eighth. Turns. Brings up center fielder.
Aces holding a 7-4 lead. Bottom eight. Tack on a run here would be nice.
Righty versus righty. Engel squares around to bunt at the first pitch. It's bobbled by Harris, the pitcher, twice. And when he gathers it up, no chance to get the speedy angle. That will be an E1. But Adam Engel gets on base for his third time today. As we well know, we've said it a lot, a threat to go on the base pass has already stolen a bag. And with one out and Engel on first, they'll bring up Chase Numata. Righty versus lefty. Pitch. Fastball that's taken low. Count 1-0, Numata, an RBI single in his last at bat in the sixth, kind of capped off everything. Before the 1-0 pitch, Harris fires back to first, diving in safely as Engel. One ball, no strikes, bottom of the eighth. Aces leading 7-4. Aces 7 runs on 8 hits, 3 errors. And Sydney 4 runs on 10 hits with 2 errors. 1-0 offering. Breaking ball that's taken in the dirt. Nice stop by Swanner. Count 2-0.
Numata hitting from the left side. Switch hitting catcher out of Hawaii. Base hit his last time round. I think he swings the bat better from his left side. He's made better contact so far this year. Only seen limited at-bats, but seems to hit it better from the left side.
2-0 offering. Fastball swung on and fisted foul down the first base side. Count 2-1. Aces have put up 7 runs, 5 in the 6th alone, and doing it all without Dylan Cousins in the lineup. Glenn Long also tuning in, saying the Aces winning helps out the Bandits. Go Aces.
Just what we're here to do is help the Bandits. Right now we're
today
here,
maybe, we're but here not to help this the weekend, Aces. Not the next weekend.
We need to help Aces right now. So thanks, Glenn. Appreciate it.
Two balls, one strike. Engel leading off a first throwback to first by Harris. Not in time to get Engel. Embark at the park day here at Melbourne Ballpark. Nice crowd. Beautiful Sunday. A little different from yesterday where it was hot and humid. 2-1 offering. Fastball swung on and a play behind home plate. Lots of pitches here for Vaughn Harris. There is some action in the Sydney bullpen. Wayne Lundgren warming up. Great eyes from the man standing next to me, Fritta. indicated by some binoculars.
Cat-like they are.
I'll leave that to the imagination. 2-1 pitch. Fastball swung on, bounced behind the bag at third. Fielded by Shepard. Long throw over to first, not in time. Runner was off on the pitch. Angle was going to be on second anyway. But an infield single by Chase Numata. That's his second hit of the ball game.
As we're going to see, this is going to be a change here. Already called for the Wayne Lundgren to come into the game. The speedy Numata hit that one down the line, third base. Zach Shepard attempt on the backhand, throw across, not in time. The speedy Numata also hitting from the left side, puts him half a step closer to the bag. Just got there by that step, as there is a pitching change here with Wayne Lundgren coming in.
And right now, if you look behind home plate, Brad Harmon, who will be up first to begin the innings, having a long conversation with home plate umpire Richard Mason, and it seems to be somewhat animated. Lundgren, tall righty, stands 199 centimeters, 98 kilograms. One of the elder statesmen on this team, 32 years old. This season, 1-0, 6.75 ERA, making his team-leading seventh appearance. Well, it ties him, actually, with Dae-Sung Koo. 5 1/3 innings pitch, 10 hits, 4 runs, all earned, struck out 7 while walking 4. How about this Aces comeback, Fredo?
Yeah, terrific comeback to this point. 7 go through here in the Australian Baseball League. We have the Delta Airlines Players of the Week. Week 1 was Ryan Searle from the Brisbane Bandits, and the hitter was Mitch Denning, who transferred from the Blue Sox across the Adelaide Bight this year. Week 2 was Marcus Solbak, who threw that terrific game for the Blue Sox in Game 1 of this series. Week 2 was Marcus Solbak, and David Candelis won the hitter of the week. Last week was Craig Anderson from the Blue Sox and Thomas Coyle from the Bandits, and I'm going to put some money on Cody Bukel winning the with his outstanding performance Friday night.
I'm a betting man, and I will not see you on that bet. I won't bet the other as part of that. 12 strikeouts, setting a Melbourne Aces team record in Friday night's victory. So Lundgren in, face Harmon with runners at first and second. One away here in the bottom of the eighth. Harmon infield single in his last at bat. He is 1-for-3 with a bases loaded walk drawn. So he gets the RBI for that. That is 6 runs batted in on the year. Righty versus righty from the high set, Lundgren, and Angle drawing a throw into center field at second. Both runners will advance, and Adam Angle for the second time bothers Wayne Lundgren. This time makes him throw back to second. It was a low throw, unable to be dug out of the dirt by Lundgren. Bounced into center field, and instead of runners at first and second, it's runners at second and third.
That's what speed will do for you. Adam Engel was pecking, trying to look for the steal of third, which at times can be a lot easier than stealing second. So he was bouncing around out there. His Blue Sox tried to turn around and pick him off. Low in the dirt, as you said, the ball ended up in center field. The Blue Sox infield has come up now with the runners advancing to second and third. Try and cut the run at the plate.
Infield playing in. Righty versus righty. Pitch from Lundgren. Fastball that's taken high and tight on Harmon. Count 1-0. That is what you call being a pest on the base pass.
Absolutely. And speed's always that great thing. It can really be pesty for infielders, pitchers, catchers. You've got to be aware of people with speed.
The 1-0 offering. Fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike. A liberal outside corner call from home plate umpire Richard Mason. I've really enabled the word liberal to come into my vocabulary.
There's a fan down here in the yellow shirt. He is telling me it was way outside.
1-1, 1-1, 1-out. Pitch to Harmon. Fastball that's taken high. Count 2-1, a hitter's count. Aces up by a score of 7-4 here in the bottom half of the eighth. Looking for some insurance runs, likely it's still Kazuki Miyata's ball game. He'll enter his fourth inning of work in the bottom half of the ninth. Up by three, looking for more. Lundgren from the stretch, 2-1 pitch. Fastball that hits the outer edge for a strike. Count to a two.
Real opportunity to tack on another run here. As you said, 7-4 lead to the Aces. Blue Sox infield is up. A hard hit ball straight at them. They'll come to the plate if the speedy angle goes.
Engel on third, Numata on second. Lundgren, glove up by his chin. Delivery, breaking ball, swung on and chopped down the third base side. Foul, Harmon protects, which you really have to with this strike zone. Count remains 2-2.
Yeah, Harmon be trying to drive, knock in the two, speeding Numata out at second. Then we've already talked about the qualities of Engel's speed. Pesty can be a good way of putting it.
The 2-2 delivery. Fastball swung on, chopped over towards the racing home as Engel. It's bobbled by Shepard, only plays the first, and it retires Harmon. The speed by Engel gets it done. That's RBI number 7 on the year for Brad Harmon, an RBI ground out. Numata the third, two outs, and the Aces take a 8-4 lead here in the bottom of the eighth.
There's a perfect example of good speed. The ball was a one hopper to third base, but on contact, Engel was off. Third base, Zach Shepard had to wait for the ball to come down to him. That allows he had no play at the plate to try and get Engel. He goes to first base, retires Harmon, fielder's choice on that play, but Harmon knocks in the run. Aces take the lead 8-4 now.
Brings up Kellin Deglan. RBI ground out in the third. Walked and scored in the sixth. Righty versus lefty. First pitch. Fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. Aces match their largest lead from last night. They did it twice. Up 5-1 and 8-4. Up 8-4 again today.
Yep.
The 0-1 offering. Fastball swung on, driven to deep left field. Back is Howe at the track, at the wall. He looks up, and this ball's gone. Second home run in as many nights for Kellin Deglan. Team leading fifth on the season. And the Aces, they've now scored 8 unanswered runs. They take a 10-4 lead here in the bottom of the eighth.
Yeah, real turnaround from last night. Early in the game, the Blue Sox scored 3 in the first innings, and they had outscored the Aces by a score of 11-0. That has instantly stopped after that first innings, and now the Aces have turned it around. The ball's driven the other way. The wind did help it get over.
Ready, first pitch. Fastball that's taken on the outside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. Phenomenal opposite field power from Deglan. 0-1 pitch, overhand breaking ball that's grounded back up the middle. Backhanded by Lysart behind the back at second, no throw. He's safe. That's an infield single, his second hit of the ball game. The ball hit the pitcher Lundgren, likely on his foot, deflected into Lysart's glove, but couldn't get the handle of the ball and really had no chance either way.
There was a comment from a Blue Sox fan that the Blue Sox have capitulated here. They want to get on the plane and go home right now. The Aces will continue to swing the bats. Good for the confidence, knock guys around.
Righty versus lefty, first pitch to Werns, a fastball that's taken low. Count 1-0. So last night, Sydney scored 8 unanswered runs. Today, the Aces score 8 unanswered runs. Baseball's a funny game.
It can be a really funny game.
1-0 pitch. Fastball swung on and driven into the right center field gap, ranging in and calls off the center fielder Glenn and retires Warren for the final out here in the eighth. But the Aces, they tack on 3 more runs, highlighted by Deglan, 2-run home run. 3 runs on 3 hits, 1 error, and 1 man left on base. Going into the ninth inning, Sydney down to their final 3 outs. Had their largest lead of the ball game. They're up 10-4 here at Melbourne Ballpark. top half of the ninth inning. Aces up by a score of 10-4, product of an offensive surge where they have scored 8 unanswered runs, 5 in the bottom of the 6th, 3 in the bottom of the 6th. And Kazuki Miyata, who's really been the silent hero for the Aces, entering his 4th inning of work, he will see Dean, Glenn, and Swanner to try to finish off this game. Lefty versus lefty, first pitch. Fastball and tight on Dean. Count 1-0. The Aces, if they were to come away with a victory tonight, they would split the series 2 games apiece. Have to give this team credit after a demoralizing loss last night, where they were up by 4 runs on 2 separate occasions, ended up losing by 4. Come back in this one, 1-0 pitch, fastball that's taken low. Count 2-0, and especially Fritta, when they were down 3-0 in the first inning.
Yeah, 3-0 in the first innings. There was a feeling amongst the crowd, oh no, here we go. But to their credit, the Aces really stuck to go, and there's 2 big innings in the 6th and the 8th.
2-0 offering, fastball swung on and flared down the third base side, foul and out of play.
There was some action down in the pen. That is now sat down. This game is Miata's to bring home now. 3 quick outs. We'll see that happen. Yeah, the 5 runs in the 6th and the 3 runs in the 8th have really been big innings for the Aces, holding a 10-4 lead.
2-1 count, nobody out. Top of the 9th, Aces up by 6. 2-1 pitch, fastball swung on, rolled over towards second. 3 hops to Harmon. Fields fires over to first. And in plenty of time, first out here in the 9th. Sydney down to their final 2 outs, and will bring up Alex Glenn.
Sort of feel the appreciation in the crowd also. They know they're on the cusp of a win here. Each play is getting a nice round of applause.
Glenn's had a nice night at the plate so far. 2-for-4. Reach base 3 times. RBI single in the 6th. Aces started their surge in the 6th inning. The breaking point of this game, or really the turning point, had to have been Justin Huber's RBI double.
Yeah,
they got Jason Popishaw, the manager for Sydney, tossed out of the game.
Yeah, it really seemed to be. There was some animation from Vaughn Harris, the catcher Will Swanner. Popishaw came out, was very animated with plate umpire Richard Mason, ended up being tossed out of this game. And since then, the Aces have gone on a tear and hold a 10-4 lead.
1-0 offering from Miyata. Fastball that's taken low. Count 2-0. Glenn has taken 2 fastballs, both low and inside. 1 away. Top of the 9th. Aces looking for a series split to take him into their next road stand with Brisbane Happy. 2-0 pitch. Fastball that's taken right down the heart of the plate for a strikeout. 2-1. Fritta stretching right to the right of me, trying to go in and throw a couple innings. Or?
This be the old pitching injury, but I've got the sore arm.
You haven't thrown anything.
I haven't thrown in 20 years. That's how long it's been sore for, 20 years. You think there's something majorly wrong there?
2-1 pitch. Check swing at a fastball, and Glenn does go around. Count 2-2. If Miyata were to finish out this ballgame, he'd get the win. Hayden Gobbold will get a no decision. 5 innings pitch. Giving up 3 runs. 2-2 offering. Breaking ball. Take a corner for a call. Third. A bender buckles the knees of Glenn. Fans on their feet. And the 4th strikeout of the game for Kazuki Miyata brings Sydney down to their final out.
There's a strike all the way. Great pitch from Miyata. Caught the outside corner. Really nice breaking ball. Alex Glenn, all he could do was stand and walk off. Called 3rd strike. 2 outs here. Top of the 9th innings. Aces 10-4 in front. Miata's been terrific in this relief spot here.
He has retired now 9 straight batters. Brings up Will Swanner. Lefty versus righty. First pitch. Fastball taken on the outside corner for a strike. Count 0-1. 2 outs, top of the 9th inning. Aces up by a score of 1 out away from a win in this series finale and a series. The 0-1 pitch. Fastball that hits the outside corner for a called third strike. Count 0-2. And just like that, front of the Aces are not only an out away from a victory, but they're also a strike away from ending this ballgame.
Yeah, this would be a good turnaround if they can shut this down now, take the win. You can hear the crowd getting involved here. Yada to finish it right here on this pitch.
Swanner down to his final strike. The 0-2 pitch, breaking ball. Swung on a missed strike three. Kazuki Miyata finishes off the job for the Aces, highlighted by 8 unanswered runs from the 6th inning on. The Aces, a come-from-behind victory in this one. They get the series split with a 10-4 victory here at Melbourne Ballpark today.
Yeah, fantastic win in the end. Giving up 3 runs in the first innings on what looked to be some relatively sloppy baseball to start the game from the Aces. But to come back and fight their way back into this game, scored 2 in the third, 5 in the 6th, 8th, to end up taking the lead and winning this game 10-4 was a phenomenal effort. Miyata in relief was really terrific. And also taking this and now going up to Brisbane next weekend for a series up there. Tremendous win by the Aces to split this series against the Sydney Blue Sox.
Sydney Blue Sox get a taste of their own medicine from last night. They came back from not one but 2 come from behind 4-run deficits, ended up winning the game 12-8. Today we're down 3-0, then 4-2, came back and won 10-4. Aces 10 runs on 11 hits, 3 errors. Sydney 4 runs on 3 errors as well. This Aces offense, Fritta, who had really been struggling coming into the series, the last 3 games they had double-digit hit totals.
Yeah, and there was a 1 innings there where they had back-to-back walks and a sack by Scott Wern, and then back-to-back doubles, as you mentioned, by Justin Huber, driving in runs. Josh Hendricks driving in runs. Was a terrific innings that really turned this game around for the Aces here. And then a long home run by Kellin Deglan was terrific as well. Also going the other way. So all in all, you know, consider take the first innings out of this game. The Aces dominated this final game, end up splitting the series at 2 apiece against the Blue Sox.
If there's a chance for a series and season-changing victory, this might be it today, with getting contributions from a guy like Justin Huber, who's been such a mainstay in this lineup for 5 years, not knowing how much exactly he has to provide for this team. He's getting a little bit older, didn't play that much leading up to the season, and for him to come and tie the game up with a 2-run double down the line, it's huge.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, you can see the guys walk a little taller when Justin Huber's in the lineup. Former big leaguer with Kansas City and San Diego Padres, Minnesota Twins. So he really is a bit of a barometer for this team. Him himself and Brad Harmon, barometers for how this team's going. And a big double right in the middle of the game there seemed to turn the fortune. And a great win in the end.
If you look down on the field right now, a post-game interviews are with Kazuki Miyata and Kome Fujisawa. That's their last game in an Aces uniform. So how about Miyata going out in style, 4 innings pitch, 5 strikeouts, only gives up 1 run and earns the victory for the Aces.
Yeah, I think that's why Tommy Thompson may have just let him go to really stretch, just air the arm out and keep going, because he's going to be rested now. He'll head back to Japan, have his Christmas, and then the month of January off for his before spring training gets underway. And it also rests the arms of the Aces players that are going to be here for the rest of the season. So Tommy Thompson really does show a lot of faith in his players, allows them to go out there and perform. And in this case, Miyata did a terrific performance in the middle part of that game. And, you know, great win in the end by the Aces.
Final score, Aces win by a score of 10-4, they improve to 4-8 on the year. Sydney falls to 9-7 on the season. Aces will be back in action next on Friday, so 5 days from now at Brisbane, their second trip to the Brisbane Bandits. So 4-game series, 1 game on Friday, 1 game on Saturday, 2 games on Sunday. But for now, savor this victory. Aces win by a final score. For Alex Cohen, well, I'm Alex Cohen, and for Craig Koenig, we say so long here from Melbourne Ballpark. Have a great rest of the weekend.